coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Christmas trees are getting pulled down from government buildings and parks all across America. The anti-God morons don't even realize that it's actually a pagan symbol. Though beautiful and expropriated, that's fine with me. And now they're declaring you criticize any of our agenda, period, whether it's turning your guns in or letting the TSA bob for apples or criticizing the lifestyle we're promoting to your children, we will get you fired. We will get you kicked out of your job. We will make you destitute. But the family of the Duck Dynasty patriarch came out today and said, we're looking at leaving the show, basically. We can't see the show going on. Statements up on Infowars.com. They said, we can't see our family going forward with the show. In fact, there's the quote, we cannot imagine the show without Phil Robertson. So boom, that's the only action they could take. And they should go off and start their own cable channel, guaranteed. They're business people, they're capitalists, they're Americana. And this is, I mean, who watches A&E? A&E has very low ratings outside of a few shows. And of course, Disney owns A&E. So I called for a boycott yesterday amongst everyone else about the same time. There's a Facebook page with a million likes right now, but they may try to censor that. I should have thought of this. We're going to launch right now. Paul Watson, as we speak, is creating a Facebook that we'll post on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com that you can make go mega viral. Let's get it with 5 million likes so that people get real hardcore info instead of a debate about homosexuality, not homosexuality. They want to make it about that, to make it about civil rights for folks that already have them. This is about being tolerant of other people's views that you don't agree with if you're a gay activist or whatever. And that's what Camille Paglia, who came out about her sexual proclivity when it wasn't cool, when there was pressure. And she said this is a Soviet Stalinist style operation. And that is exactly what I called it yesterday. This is Stalinist, showing she's smart and has done her historical research. This is Stalinist. Paglia, Duck Dynasty uproar, utterly fascist, utterly Stalinist. Boom! It's both fascist and communist. Both of them did this. And folks, if they can pull Christmas trees down and nativity scenes all over the country and at military bases and crosses that have been there, in some cases 1,000 years in Europe, if they can do that, they can do anything, ladies and gentlemen. So our Facebook is going to be important because it's going to point out the larger, deeper agenda. And Paul Watson is creating it right now. In the next 20 minutes, it'll be up on Infowars.com. And then you can add your comments, your analysis, your points. So it's going to go live. It'll be on, we've got a bunch of Facebooks. One of them's got 600,000, a bunch of others. We got over 2 million likes total on all our Facebooks. I'm going to have this posted on all of our Facebook platforms, 2 million likes strong, so that we can then promote it out to everyone. And Facebook's been known to then pull down pages, so it's important to make your own pages as well in case they pull ours or this other one. But this is a First Amendment issue. They can claim, well, you know, it's the First Amendment right of A&E to do this. And that's right. But if you're going to do something to somebody for a off-the-cuff thing in a magazine, their personal views, and then persecute them, and then use it as a way to persecute everybody else's free speech, we have free speech to boycott you. It's like the head of Pearl Jam came out and said, I don't like these people, Eddie Vedder, who they're trying to stop my free speech disagreeing with me. They're fascists. No, no, no. Free speech doesn't mean that we then agree with you and adopt what you say. That's not censorship when we disagree with you, bozo. That's turnabout's fair play. That's free speech right back at you. And you people aren't into free speech. You're not liberals. Thomas Jefferson was a liberal. I'm a liberal. You're dirtbag, Stalinist, pieces of frickin' filth.
The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented, a 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield Nascent Iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield Nascent Iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. Live from the InfoWars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
It's already Friday, the 20th day of December, 2013. I am coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas, Austin, where we had to pass in the last legislative session a law so that Christmas trees and nativity scenes can be displayed on the holiday for which the holiday is named Christmas or Christ Mass, the meeting of followers of Christ for the birth of the Savior. But you see, the system, the globalists who've made the state God, like any group that's conquered and usurped another, is overriding Christmas. The Christians overwrote many of the Druidic rituals and the Tannenbaum brought in during the darkest part of the year. The ancients believed the 25th of December, the evergreen tree. And so it became the Tannenbaum. Tannenbaum, O Tannenbaum. And then was brightly adorned. It now, the ancient pagan symbol usurped by Christians, now has been usurped again by pagans, but pagans that worship the state, absolutely, totally fitting. And it's their act of dominance, their act of control in our face that they could try to remove this image. And you notice during this Christmas time that there's an all-out assault on free speech because the globalists are losing the info war. Pentagon said that 3 months ago using the term info war, because we have the white-hot burning sword of truth that if we'll simply take it in our hands and take to the field, we'll dismember frauds and dismember parasitic ideas and systems like a hot knife through butter. But you have to have a fighting spirit. You have to be aware of what's going on. You have to decide you're not done. You've got to decide you're not rolling over. You got to get off your back where you present your belly to these wolves, believing they're going to lick you in the face. You don't present your belly to wolves. That's what causes hell on earth. And that's a message to all the timid people out there that think you're going to be safe sitting on your butts. I do not do what I do because I've got courage, ladies and gentlemen. I do what I do because I recognize a full-out authoritarian takeover when I see one, and I leap into action because I want to preserve my flesh and that of my family. But more importantly than preserving my flesh and my providence and my property and my independence is that I want to preserve my way of life, and I want to instruct my children in the ways of my ancestors. I don't want my children instructed in the ways of a bunch of globalist, inbred, control freak, authoritarian trash. I'm not your property. My mind's not your property. My soul is not your property, and my children are not your property, and their children are not your property. Do you hear me, enemy? You shall not pass. Now, my friends, we are live and broadcasting worldwide on this day. And I want us all to commit today to lift up a standard of liberty in our own lives and to stand against any that attempt to make us adopt their way of life, their religion, their ideas, their systems. Liberty and justice for all. That is this republic. And we will not have our holidays, our systems, our sacred rights trampled anymore and overwritten with the pitiful offering that you bring us. All the globalist ugly music and ugly plastic corporate culture, we vomit it up. You have force-fed us long enough, and America and the world needs to seek God's face and repent and ask that God pump the poison out of our soul and out of our guts. Because we are under a spell, and we have to become aware of this mind control and break free from the New World Order scientific technocracy and all of its technocratic incantations. The beauty of Christmas and of the carols is what they hate. The beauty of what is at the center of it, Christ, is what they hate. Because even if you don't believe in Jesus Christ, the historical figure, you should believe in those ideas. And you should ask why they are opposed tenfold ten on every front by the powers of this earth. And the God of this world. Thank you for joining us on the 20th day of December 2013. And I am fired up today because so much is happening. And we can see the battle being joined right now. Now, continuing, Piers Morgan has come out and said the First Amendment shouldn't protect vile bigots like Phil Robertson. So he should not have his speech. And once they define what a bigot is, all speech is taken. You see, Piers Morgan doesn't just want to remove the Second Amendment or the Fourth Amendment or the Tenth Amendment. He wishes to remove the most sacred and first amongst all rights, the right of speech, the right of expression, the right of art, the right of literature, the right of independent thought and individualism, and the right to follow free will path that you choose and whatever flame you are drawn to. We are not drawn to the same flame as you, peers, and we will never, ever bow to the chains which you lay out before us like roses, because we see the poison thorns. Piers Morgan, First Amendment shouldn't protect vile bigots like Phil Robertson. National boycott launched against Duck Dynasty censorship. Adon Salazar, Infowars.com yesterday. Duck Dynasty family releases statement on suspension of Phil Robertson. Says we're backing him. We may leave the show. We can't go on without him. Bravo. It's the only course. That's what it's all about. Standing up for free speech, which is just like standing up for kin. Because the First Amendment has been hard fought and hard won and is our kin. All of those first 10 amendments, which don't give us rights, simply point out what already existed, are the human birthright, the human experience, and are our kin. And we can't turn our back on those liberties any more than we could turn our back on our fathers, our brothers, our wives, our sisters, our daughters. We are together, and too long has the human community been divided against each other. And that's what they're doing with all of this, is another wedge issue to make it look like it's a civil right to ban people's free speech. No, it's not. And it is out of love of free speech, not out of hatred of a bunch of grandstanders who want to force their way of life on children. This is Stalinistic, as Camille Paglia has come out and said. Ultra-Stalinistic. This is what they did in the Soviet Union. Paglia, Duck Dynasty uproar, utterly fascist, utterly Stalinist. And then Paul Watson wrote two absolutely essential, absolutely key articles on Infowars.com. First, Watson came out and said, should the Bible be banned as hate speech this morning? And then pointed out in Canada and Germany and places, if preachers read from the admonitions against homosexuality, from the Levitical Jewish law of Moses 3,000 plus years ago, that they be fired and taken to jail and clapped in irons to serve long prison sentences. Now, you notice Christianity's fair game to attack. Christianity's fair game. If you even talk about banning the Quran, cities will burn. Watson wrote that article to open the debate up. The Quran is hate speech, that's in quotes, and should be banned. The exact same headlines, except instead of Bible, it says Quran. Duck Dynasty controversy. Bible to be banned is hate speech? That's in quotations. The Quran is hate speech and should be banned. Paul Joseph Watson. There you go. So we ask the question here, it's okay to ban and restrict the Bible and preachers preaching from it in the West now, the former home of free speech in the Renaissance and the Enlightenment. Is it also okay? No, you can put out Muslim and even menorahs, those are in public in front of the Capitol, but you will not put a cross out. And you will not put a Christmas tree out. And I say the Rockefellers should stop having their Christmas tree as well. Oh, you say, well, it's private property. Oh, but it's in a public commons. You see, they had to pass a law in Texas a few years ago. You can look this up. In fact, I want to give the exact law. Will you guys pull up Texas passes law for Christian symbols at Christmas? Perry got it signed. And I'm not a huge fan of Rick Perry, but I'm a fan of that. Again, Rick Perry has a lot of good rhetoric. He just a lot of times stabs us in the back, but he has been being better lately because he understands he needs to be more Tea Party to actually run for president and win, but that's a side issue. Even George P. Bush running for Texas, land commissioner is doing the same song and dance. The point is that we're sending our reporters out, Leanne McAdoo and Jakari Jackson. Leanne will be live. Jakari's going to be shooting question and answer for the Nightly News. I may have him on as well live at 12:30 coming up in about an hour and 10 minutes. from down at the Capitol there in front of the Christmas tree right at the end of Congress. We're going to be doing some interviews with the public there. If you want to go down and give your view on this, 12:30, not on the Capitol property, right there in front of the Christmas tree, right there in the public commons, right where Congress dead ends, there to the Capitol.
The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalist by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
You better watch out, you sure better cry. You're at least gonna pout, and I'm telling you why. Primacy is leaving your town.
Is your cell phone being used to build a profile on you? Give the gift of privacy and block unwanted cell phone spying with the Privacy Case from PrivacyCase.com.
They're making their list, they're checking them twice. They're gonna make up who's been naughty or nice.
The problem is real, and so is the solution. Go to PrivacyCase.com because
they see you when you're sleeping. They listen when you're awake. They can tell us all you've been bad when you've been good. So get yourself a privacy case.
Now through December 31st, buy yourself an American-made privacy case and give one for only $79.95 each. Go to PrivacyCase.com today. The Privacy Case, because there is a case for privacy.
We all know that Berkey water purification systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey guy offers amazing specials for Berkey water filtration systems. The Berkey light systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey light system today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey light, the Berkey guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
Yes, family and friends are gathering to give gifts and wish health and security. But why not enhance cell phone and wireless device security all year with Block It Pocket? A family-owned American business, we now have two spectacular holiday specials. Find them now at our new website, blockitpocket.com, or call 888-315-9618. Hurry, holiday special ends Christmas Day. Give the gift of security from blockitpocket.com, wishing you health, freedom, and liberty.
Did you know that organic sulfur can cleanse and defend your body against the poisons we're exposed to each day? Organic sulfur crystals from sulfurdefense.com help by forcing oxygen and nutrition into your cells while eliminating heavy metals, contaminants, and damaging radiation. Defend yourself and family from toxic assault with one of the most critical and essential minerals available today. Order online at sulfurdefense.com. That's sulfurdefense.com, or call 800-593-6273.
We've got it. This transmission is coming to you.
Waging war on corruption, crashing through the lies and disinformation. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Who is that guy doing those liners? Pretty good. It's not the Cobra Commander, is it?
Cobra.
Or Optimus Prime.
Autobots transform and roll out.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on this live Friday worldwide broadcast. I am your host, Alex Jones. So here's the article. This is out of New York Daily News. Governor Rick Perry signs Merry Christmas Bill into law, allowing government buildings, schools, you name it, to display religious symbols as long as at least one secular or other religious symbol is also displayed. At the signing ceremony, high school cheerleaders wore T-shirts that read, "I cheer for Christ." Bingo. And again, folks, you're not under the First Amendment. You have the right to free speech. And in a letter, Thomas Jefferson said, we should not have a state-run religion. We should have separation of church and state. Well, yeah, that's why the whole country started. So you couldn't have the Protestants say they were going to run the country, or the Catholics say they're going to run the country, or Jews, you know, coming and saying we're going to make that the state-run religion, or anybody else for that matter. You could practice whatever religion you wanted to, but the country celebrates Christmas that is pan-Christian across the board, 2,000 years old. And it's what unifies Christians. But it's also a good time for forgiving each other and spending time together in the dark of winter. And it's a great holiday. It's now they've already overwritten it with Santa Claus and Coca-Cola since the 30s. Before that, Santa Claus, unless you talk about the Netherlands or whatever, was more of a Krampus-type character who would come with coal and take you to hell. They would, in the last 400 years, they banned Christmas for over 100 years in London because the city routinely burned to the ground during the riots. Santa Claus was a Freddy Krueger person, literally, with knives on his fingers and a striped shirt and a hat. That's where they get Freddy Krueger from, just so you don't know, was for a couple hundred years, it was a Freddy Krueger ghoul. And then it was like Devil's Night, like Halloween is now in Detroit, where people would go out and burn and murder. And the word was, they had a movie recently, I didn't see it, where all crime has been stopped, but one night a year you're allowed to kill whoever you want if you can get away with it. Everybody locks themselves up in their houses then. And everybody would just go out and basically start killing each other. So they banned it. You can look that up in the Encyclopedia Britannica. I think it was 300 years ago for about... But 350 years ago, for about 100 years, so till about 250 years ago, Christmas was banned. They would arrest you if they saw you in the Santa Claus outfit. Black boots, red and white striped shirt, people ran in terror. It was party time. Get possessed, have sex in the streets, burn buildings, kill your old enemies. I mean, this was Devil's Night. So that shows how the pagans and the psychos are always trying to override things. So they brought in the modern Santa Claus in the last 100 years and merged him with Krampus. We're going to do a report on Monday on Krampus. It's interesting culturally. But we're sending our reporters down, Ja'Kari Jackson and Leanne McAdoo. They'll be there at 12:30 on the south side of the Capitol, in front of the gates, right in front of the Christmas tree, down there doing interviews with folks on your view on the attack on Christmas and free speech that ties into Duck Dynasty. And we're going to go over all of that. And Paul Watson, any minute now, well, I got a big announcement after the break. I'll just leave it at that for everybody. But we do have these articles that are up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. The Quran is hate speech and should be banned. Central Text of Islam advocates stoning homosexuals to death. So according to what they're saying about Christianity, ban those areas of Christianity, according to what they're getting into, then this should be banned as well. And guys, during the break, remind me, I need a new headset and get rid of this cord. It's stripped out and just keeps coming out of the plug for days, and I just need to get rid of it. I'm going to throw it in the trash. That's driving me crazy. It keeps falling out of the deal. So here it is. Christmas trees banned at Texas school called draconian. So it doesn't matter that the law is already in place to allow the First Amendment and for culture to be... This is culture. This is what Christmas is. Xmas. Now they call it winter holiday. And it's cult-like, and it's a big deal. So when we get back, I'm going to tell you about Piers Morgan. He wants free speech banned in America. And we'll also tell you they had a vote on CNN who the number one story of the year was. And, of course, you could probably guess what it was, but we'll tell you on the other side. That article's up on Infowars.com. And then the big announcement, something Paul Watson is launching with myself on the other side in defense of free speech. Straight ahead on the other side of this break. I'm Alex Jones.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filters today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Alex Jones here with a message to fellow freedom lovers. The prognosis for the entire planetary economic system runs from bad to worse. The globalist model is to shut down societies and starve patriots out until they acquiesce to the global takeover. That's why we've assembled the most vital and important preparedness items at InfoWarsShop.com. These are items that I did research on, that I personally use. We've got the Life Straw, so you can turn fetid water into safe water anywhere you go. The K-Tor hand crank generator to charge up key equipment during power outages or out in the field. Strategic Relocation, 3rd edition by Joel Skousen. When Disaster Strikes by Matthew Stein. Therosafe, used by Homeland Security to protect yourself during any radiological event. Hand crank shortwave AM/FM radios. Everything that we've researched and found to be the best is available at InfoWarsShop.com, and your purchase makes our InfoWar possible. We're getting prepared. Are you? InfoWarsShop.com.
The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
It is essential if you are a radio or TV viewer, radio listener, TV viewer, or if you're a supporter of the First Amendment and just happened across this broadcast today, to go to InfoWars.com. We just launched a new Facebook page. I should have thought of this yesterday. That says, new Facebook page, boycott A&E, support free speech. Now, there's one saying boycott A&E, but we want to point out the whole free speech act aspect of this and really get to the issue of this is not tolerance. This is police state and Stalinistic, as gay activist Camille Paglia has properly pointed out. And she's a very reasonable, smart lady about the culture and how the system is using this whole liberal movement as a basically cultural takeover to be bigoted against people that aren't basically communist, socialist, and who don't adopt their New World Order views and their anti-human views. And I agree with her breakdown of that. They're trying to break down the family to bring in total cultural control. They're trying to destroy men. And it has nothing to do with empowering other people's civil rights. So, new Facebook page, boycott A&E, support free speech. I do not agree with what you have to say, but I'll defend it to the death. Your right to say it. is the subheadline that Watson has there. So whether you agree with the statements or agree with them or disagree with them, it is absolutely essential to go to Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com and to find the link that we have at the bottom of the article. We should also add it to the top of the article. It's Infowars Free Speech. And we need to defend free speech. We need to promote free speech. We need to educate the public. And so we have other Facebooks with 2 million likes. Our biggest one, because we created a whole bunch, I guess about 4 or 5 years ago, actually, activists did and then gave them to us. We appreciate that. Has 676,964 likes, and that's the Alex Emmerich Jones. That's my official Facebook, because later they made me actually contact him and give him my driver's license to prove that it's actually mine, so folks couldn't spoof me as they were doing. And we're getting this new page posted on that page as well. Absolutely essential that everyone go to our main Facebook, and that and we're going to have it added there. Paul's doing that right now. And then everyone go to the InfoWars to find the actual link. It's InfoWars Free Speech. Facebook.com/InfoWars Free Speech. One word. And we're going to really beef it up with all the articles about free speech. How the authoritarians take fake civil rights, which a fake civil right is saying you can't disagree with my lifestyle. You can't have your own church where you say that homosexuality is a sin. Along with adultery. And I mean, is that bigoted now to say adultery ends up hurting kids and isn't a good idea? Does it mean everybody's perfect? Does it mean we all throw stones at each other? Does it mean we all say you're bad? That you're inherently a bad person? No. Drinking too much is a sin according to the Bible. I tend to agree with that. I mean, it is. Drinking too much is bad for you. It is. A sin is a sin against God's creation and against God. Our body's supposed to be a temple. But if you don't agree with that, that's fine. That's your right, but I don't have to adopt your ideas. You shouldn't take my tax money, set up a government training camp called a public school, and teach first graders through 12th graders how to have anal sex and how to masturbate. They've turned promoting pedophilia and the state teaching kids sexual stuff into a right and into tolerance. It's outrageous. And again, it's because they know if they can set the precedent to kick a kid out of school because they were seen playing with a Nerf gun with their friends in the backyard, and the neighbor knows to call the school, and the school actually acts on it outside of their jurisdiction and kicks them out of school, that's crazy. But it's meant to be crazy. New York, Garden City. Two guys are out washing their car in their own driveway at their own house. Cop comes up and says, listen, your neighbor called. You're not allowed to wash your car in your own driveway. This is not your private property. And they're doing it across the board, the TSA, all of it. We have to come together for free speech. Folks, I don't get up here on my show and bash gay people. I don't, over the years, 18 years on air, it's not my issue. Until now, because I can't turn a television on, I can't open a newspaper up. I mean, I am sick of it. If I loved a song and I heard it 5,000 times, folks, I'd get sick of it. You know songs you own the CD or the record or the tape cassette or whatever, or you've had it on your iPad or iPod, and you've heard it 500 times and you get sick of it, and then you hear it a few years later and you're like, man, I'm still sick of that song. Yeah, I mean, I'm like neutral on all this stuff. I want to live my own life, live and let live, but man, I am sick of it. This is like sexual harassment is what it is. It really is. It just hit me. This whole gay mafia agenda is sexual harassment, ladies and gentlemen. And by the way, I never even thought about this in college and stuff. I shouldn't even tell these stories. I just, you know, I was a guy, so I didn't really take offense at like a girl would if some guy kept hitting on her over and over again. But I mean, I had have guys follow me in my car, hit on me constantly in class, just absolutely follow me to the gym, find out where I lived, come knock on the door. I mean, I probably 15 times was absolutely trailed by Pepe Le Pew gay guys because I was pretty good looking, you know, back when I was in college. And the point is that I was like, no, that's all right. I mean, that's all right. But here's the thing. It almost, if a woman was doing that, it almost would be kind of freaky. You know what I mean? I'm attracted to women. But the point is, I don't hate people that just because they're attracted to something. My issue is this is authoritarianism, ladies and gentlemen, and it's pushed, and it's pushed, and it's pushed, and it's pushed, and it's pushed. And man, I feel like I'm being Pepe Le Pew here. And the larger issue is then you've got groups that have gotten on the bandwagon, the pedophiles, promoting the sexualization of children, and the UN and saying NAMBLA is good, and the American Psychological Association saying it's not a problem. No, it is a problem. And if you get around my kids until they're 16, I'm coming after you. It's real simple. Anybody touches my kids or comes after them, especially my daughters, I mean, you are going to get some trouble. There's a few things that'll punch my buttons, but anybody ever hurts my kids, you know what's going to happen to you. And I'm not going to say any more. Default, you're not going to like what happens to you. And it comes down to that. And that's why I've gotten so angry. This is a mafia. This is an authoritarianism. And there's big pushback. There's a million likes on a brand new deal out there to boycott A&E. But I think they're saying some things that are good, some things I don't agree with. Ours is all about free speech and all about how this is fascism. And I'm going to post a link to the Camille Paglia statement in there as well. Because we need to unify around the First Amendment and not let this be a wedge issue. It's very, very simple. And I personally am just really sick and tired of all of this being foisted upon everyone. So that's where this stands. Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.com. I need to tweet it out at Real Alex Jones. Watson's already done it for me 2 minutes ago. So retweet that at Real Alex Jones. New Facebook page, Boycott A&E, Support Free Speech. Very important. Free speech doesn't mean intolerance and censorship of anyone who disagrees with you. That's a piece breaking down the live show. The Quran is hate speech and should be banned. Central Text of Islam advocates stoning homosexuals to death. And again, we're quoting what someone said on Fox News yesterday. We're not saying that. Even though it's in quotes, some people don't understand that and are getting mad. So whatever, deal with it. Your ignorance is no excuse to violate my First Amendment. So that is just some of what's happening. Please help us. Now, here's the other news. Let me just tell you who's coming up on the broadcast today. Larry Klayman, who stood up against the censorship of CNN, and it really blew up in their face. He's going to pop in for 15 minutes at the start of the hour. The guy that's beaten the NSA and gotten the judge to say it's clearly unconstitutional, now it's going to trial. Big deal, and he admonished the NSA. Huge victory. He's going to be popping back in to talk about what happened on CNN. And speaking of CNN, Piers Morgan came out. This is up on drudgereport.com. That's from Breitbart. Piers Morgan, First Amendment shouldn't protect vile bigots like Phil Robertson. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. He doesn't support the First Amendment either. And that's what I keep warning everyone about. Folks, I go out and demonstrate for the First Amendment and get roughed up by cops in the rain in Dallas. By the sheriff's deputies, to be clear. The Dallas police were apologized and totally freaked out by it. It was the feds ordering the deputies who were federalized to do it. Totally criminal. I go out and I fight and I go out and protest the NSA, myself and my crew. Jakari Jackson's done it. Josh Owens, Anthony Gucciardi, Weldon Henson. We go out and we defend everything. Farmers' rights. I've gone and protested the Klan more than a dozen times. We've dug up some of those videos and done it with them death threatening me. And I will go out and I will protest the new Black Panther Party when they're saying kill white people. I'm sick of all this crap. We need to come together as humans under basic liberty and protect everyone's rights. If they get us all fighting with each other over all these little sub-issues, they've divided and conquered us. That's what it comes down to. And that's what MSNBC and the Democratic Party and all of them are there to promote is authoritarianism in the name of civil rights, taking our rights away so someone else isn't offended. We saw a movie star this week say, you shouldn't be able to call someone fat. And then I saw some other pundits say that. You know, arrest someone if they call you fat. Arrest bullies. And the anti-bully training in schools, national study showed this year, has tripled bullying. Yeah, Jennifer Lawrence. That's a movie star, right? I don't really know. Hunger Games. Oh, she did that? I think she's a very talented actress and very feminine, but also I think she's a great heroine. I like strong, beautiful women, and that really bums me out. Oh, but she's not the main actress. Who's the brunette? That's her. She just doesn't look attractive there. Oh, whatever. Just what a bummer. Just get it off the screen. It's just so horrible. Anyways, it's just and they're getting all these airheads on television to go, yeah, I think we should do whatever the president says, Britney Spears, or I think we should ban calling someone fat, or yeah, let's ban literature that criticizes something. I mean, this is intellectual book burning. It's fascism. It's Stalinistic commie garbage. 101, incontrovertible, debate's over, it's happening. And that's why I'm so upset today, ladies and gentlemen. I am so upset right now because it just gets more and more crazy. But they're doing this because they know we're waking up and taking action. And if they can take some country bumpkin hillbilly, some lovable hillbilly, everybody loves the American story of a hillbilly or somebody else, you know, striking it rich with inventions and ideas. That's the old Americana. And they genuinely are Christians. And I've seen the show a few times. They're funny. Reminds me too much of family in East Texas, quite frankly. So I've got a bunch of family looks and acts just like it. And anyways, I've turned down so many reality shows. I guess if these are so hot, I could move to East Texas and it'd literally be me broadcasting there with my family. I mean, I'm telling you, it looks like Duck Dynasty. A bunch of them have got the beards and the whole nine yards. But that's when you got the beard out in the countryside, that means you're wily and don't like the system and everything and are hillbillyish. Just, I'm telling you, it's like a uniform. And then the guys that have the cowboy hats and are shaved and everything, they're in the in-town guys and kind of laugh at the hillbillies. I'm telling you, it's all like clubs. So I got family that wears cowboy hats and John Deere hats and, you know, run businesses and operations and work and, you know, work in town. And then you've got the hillbillies that get off my land. Anyways, I'm telling you, I can't watch that show. It's like watching family or something. Because you got to know, East Texas is basically an extension of Louisiana. It's basically the same thing. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, my Uncle Joe kind of looks like Phil. Well, there's no kind of looks like him. There's no kind of. That's what my dad looks like if he had a longer beard. I mean, that's about it right there. Anyways, my dad got a big beard about 10 years ago, and I just realize he looks like Phil Robertson. This is amazing. Anyways, it is same eyes, same nose, same eyebrows. That looks like my dad. Guys, does that look like my dad if he had a longer beard? Looks like him. Pretty funny. Anyways, side issue, ladies and gentlemen. Continuing right along here today, let's get into something interesting. You know, it's funny. This morning, I was thinking about Piers Morgan for some reason, which I hardly ever think about when I was out having a jog in the dawn twilight. And I said, you know, I ought to go look at the text messages from their producers. So I went in and looked and noticed that I'd been texted by one. So I texted that one just asking, how are you doing, Alex? Like a few months ago, and I hadn't seen it and hadn't texted them back because I got so many text messages. Then I saw another one of the producers, and I sent them both text messages, and one of them texted me back saying hi. And then I challenged him. I said, look, it's now time to have me on. You know you got record 2 million viewers compared to your 500,000, and you keep sinking. Why haven't you had me back on? Well, one of the producers said, because higher-up said, it gave me too much attention. See, because I really won that, folks. I got people to think it's about disarming us, not about their debate. They're just trying to keep us safe. So I sent them a text message back, and I said, I challenge you to have me on. You could even do it via satellite taped if you're chicken. Because I did attack, you know, their Prozac sponsors and stuff. Instead of blaming guns, you know, blame. Really, what's at the core of it, or one of the key things at the core. Kind of like there's a pie that's the heart of what's happening, and a big slice of that heart, big slice of that pie is the serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Then it's the shoot 'em up video games designed to program troops to kill. Then it's the fact that the kids are always the occult, socialist, communist, Democrats, all on record. And I just don't like the fact communist, socialist, Satan worshiper, Democrat, occultist, shoot 'em up video game heads get obsessed with death and dressing up in, you know, black trench coats I mean, you see these kids at the mall or on the street, they'll be like 10 of them trying to scare you because they've got like white makeup on. And all I want to do is like, I mean, I'm a normal, loving person, but if people try to menace me, I immediately think about how I would attack all of them and just start ramming their heads into the wall. It's easier to beat up 10 people than beat up one. I'm telling you, there's just nothing like just going rah, just savagely attacking people and ramming their heads into walls. Excuse me. The point is that, I mean, you know how it is. I'm a little bit crazy today. After that jog, behind the scenes, these endorphins hit me that I haven't felt since I was like 14. I think it may be the super male vitality. But, I mean, I am literally resembling like an orc or something during the breaks. I mean, I'm not kidding. I mean, I just am really higher than a kite right now. And I had one cup of our coffee this morning, so that's not what's doing it. Bound, come on the air. We're about to go to break, but just come on the air. You guys got to get better on the fly turning that mic on. Have I been crazed today? No. You're not on the air, bro. I would think you guys would want to be part of the show, but I can never get anybody to come on air. Or, I mean, if you were on air, I didn't hear you, so it doesn't matter. was he on air, John Harmon? Yeah, that's all right. I will tell you about the Piers Morgan development when we come back on the other side. Stay with us.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee. And it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
Time and time again.
You need to come here and help us. We need assistance. Please.
Those we should be able to depend on let us down.
Federal and state and local officials saying help is on the way. Well, the folks here in Bell Harbor say show me.
Don't depend on the government to save you. Take action now so that you're prepared for the next disaster with MyPatriotSupply.com. Get the best prices on storable food, non-GMO seeds, water filtration devices, home canning equipment, survival and self-reliance books, and more at MyPatriotSupply.com. Call 866-229-0927.
We are hurting down here, and we need help immediately.
Before it's time to survive, it's time to prepare. MyPatriotSupply.com. MyPatriotSupply.com.
Get the ultimate gift at the ultimate price. The Fox Karambit Knife. The Fox Karambit Knife opens with one hand faster than you can pull a handgun. For utility, for defense, and for way less than other knives of this caliber. Go to TheUltimateKnife.com. Truly the best knife you'll ever own. And only available at TheUltimateKnife.com. Use promo code radio at checkout for free shipping. Hurry, offer good till December 25th. Get the ultimate knife at the ultimate price at TheUltimateKnife.com.
Do you need push-button heat with no batteries, no microwave, and no cords? Introducing Hot Shots, a must-have heat source for any cold-weather activity, aches and pains, and more. Hot Shots reusable heat packs come in many sizes and provide hours of soothing heat. Yes, reusable, with a lifetime warranty. Don't be left out in the cold. Call 916-214-6943 or visit reusableheat.com. Hot Shots, instant portable reusable heat anytime, anywhere. That's reusableheat.com.
Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. Get up, stand up,
tell you, the Duck Dynasty folks are going to use their fame to go forward and tell people about Why I Follow Christ, Flashback, Vowed to Quit A&E, the network band Talk of God and Guns. Now the family says they can't come back without their patriarch, and so they're doing the right thing. A&E tried to cut Jesus from family prayers. Number one rated in cable history. Palin defends. Cruz represents the American unusually ignored or mocked by liberal elites. Jindal, messed up situation. When Miley Cyrus gets laughed at, Phil Robertson gets suspended. Yeah, I mean, I turn on like TV and it shows like young teenage girls kissing each other. Obviously designed to make young girls do that, trying to sexualize our kids. It's pedophilia, folks. That's okay. But don't say, hey, we've had enough of this. This is absolute tyranny, ladies and gentlemen. And, of course, the nightmare before Christmas, 40 million credit cards and debit card accounts may have been affected. We talked some about that yesterday. But it shows how this cashless society is the problem, not the answer. Now, somebody had unplugged the mic in there, and poor John Baum was sitting there talking into deep space. How crazed have I been today, John, in a good way?
Well, the first thing you said to me this morning was, are you ready?
Yes. It is actually true. I know it's not speaking in tongues. It just feels so good to go, hungunga, hungunga. It's like caveman talk.
Yeah, it takes you back to your basic nature.
You know, we're planning on opening a restaurant where they have like nice, attractive young ladies in caveman bikinis, you know, spotted leopard prints, serving you like big things of mead and yes. beer. And there's only three things on the menu. It's like beef, pork, chicken, and then all it is a pitcher. And then you point at it and go, ugh. Doesn't that sound good?
I think the ladies will love it.
Absolutely. The ladies. No, it's a guy's place.
Yeah, but the ladies will love it, too, because they want real men.
Exactly. Well, you could have a wing, too, that'll have the real men, like football, you know, models in there, in their striped outfits as well, Fred Flintstone outfits. And exactly, the ladies can go in there, and they're like, and she's like, nah! Isn't that a good idea?
We could have hair-dragging events.
Hair-dragging event. Well, that's the thing. You flip the menu over, there's a brothel next door, and then it shows the man with the woman on his shoulder. That's not sexist at all.
No, not at all.
Folks, it's a joke. It's a joke. I don't want to get all my Christian listeners mad at me now. Everybody, it's a joke. It's some comedy. All right. And we call it, you know, Barney's Politically Incorrect or something. I don't know. Anyways, that's enough. I think we just released the ultimate idea for Las Vegas. Look, I haven't gotten to this yet, and we've got Larry Klayman coming up. Guess who CNN's number one person was on the Piers Morgan Show of the Year, according to viewers? And I bet they had a vote CNN-wide. It's 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. Is that clear? It doesn't matter how many lemmings you get out there begging to be slaves, Morgan. It's a pretty good imitation of myself. The point is that that's up there. Guess who tops Piers Morgan's 10 most memorable moments of 2013? We've got some of his sniveling guests up there making fun of me doing like a Texas accent. Because the truth is, the left, everybody, it's okay to call white rednecks names, talk bad about Southerners, Westerners. All that bigotedness is okay. And that free speech is okay. It's just our free speech that isn't allowed. We're not allowed to fight back. We're supposed to lay down. So that video of that and the rest of it is up on Infowars.com. In fact, we can show the TV viewers the poll. They've now closed the poll. You guys punch up my screen right there for folks on TV? Thank you. So guess who tops Piers Morgan 10 most memorable moments? 1776 will commence again. We try to take our firearms. You can see the video. And we beat out Bill Clinton, Charlie Sheen, Tom Hanks, Snoop Lion, Warren Buffett. All of them. All of them beaten by the voters.
Thank you for listening.
Unga Sakondo Kalmai Stanga!
Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to Big Pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products. And get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Coming up, ladies and gentlemen, in the next segment, Larry Klayman, who CNN tried to cut off the air for trying to defend himself, demonizing him for daring to fight the NSA in federal court and winning. How un-American to stand up for all of our privacy. He's going to pop in. Then Leanne McAdoo and Jakari Jackson from down in front of the Texas State Capitol at the forbidden demonic Christmas tree that different groups have been trying to have removed. They're going to be popping in on a live feed. And then Amber Lyon, also censored at CNN. Boy, CNN's just all over the place today. She's going to be joining us, three-time Emmy Award winner for her work. She's got a new book out, Peace, Love, and Pepper Spray. She's going to be joining us as well. But if you just tuned in, we have launched several things up on Infowars.com. We have the new Facebook page, Boycott A&E and Support Free Speech. It is essential that everyone go to InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com and go to that article, which we might want to just punch up on that computer in there because it, A, looks better, and B, this computer hasn't been loading right or working well. But if you, or it's not formatted correctly, I just direct here from the air, on the air. And it's very important to stand up for free speech, whether you agree what Phil Robinson said from Duck Dynasty or not. If they can bring him down and get him off the air, they can basically do anything they want. So that boycott A&E, because they're boycotting our free speech, is up on Infowars.com. Right now, we want to ask you to retweet that out on your Twitter, post that on your Facebook, and more. Yeah, and so now I can see what's happening. The site is formatted wrong, so just walk over, or I'll do it, into that room right there and ask them to reformat Watson's deal so that we can do that. So again, ladies and gentlemen, we are broadcasting worldwide today, and we are going to come back and talk to another person standing up for the Bill of Rights and Constitution, Larry Klayman. And again, Amber Lyon's coming on about the attack and how she was banned, and how $400,000 was paid by a foreign government to keep her report from airing. I mean, this is the real type of stuff that's going on. This is the real type of stuff that is happening in this country. And the real type of attacks on free speech that we're facing, not just here, but all over the world. And it is authoritarianism, but they do it through kind of a fake liberal cover that they're protecting someone else's rights. That's why they're taking your rights. And now it's coming out. NSA caught spying on EU official, investigates Google, Obamacare, heroin hit streets, White House lifts mandate for people whose insurance was canceled. Will anyone have to pay? The problem is that it's already canceled. The real thing was letting them cancel your insurance and violate the law and now double charge you. It's all a big joke. 14th change to law without congressional approval. That is that we have one branch of government now, the executive bureaucracy that is fused together. That's some of the stories up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, as well as DrudgeReport.com. that I was just looking at that we're going to be breaking down. Obviously, Harry Reid's been hospitalized. Chris Christie to sign bill for tuition breaks for illegals in private. That's because he's so conservative. So that is just some of what we're going to be getting to coming up here today. And the other big article, if they want to ban Christianity and the Bible because it criticizes homosexuality, why not ban the Quran as well? Well, that would be politically incorrect. See, it's only Christianity that really the system's trying to dismantle because it's been the dominant system. People worship that and not the state, and the state is a jealous god. So that's basically what's going on. All this and more straight ahead with First Amendment, Fourth Amendment champion Larry Klayman.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with a new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Alex Jones here with a message to fellow freedom lovers. The prognosis for the entire planetary economic system runs from bad to worse. The globalist model is to shut down societies and starve patriots out until they acquiesce to the global takeover. That's why we've assembled the most vital and important preparedness items at InfoWarsShop.com. These are items that I did research on, that I personally use. We've got the Life Straw, so you can turn fetid water into safe water anywhere you go. The K-Tor hand crank generator to charge up key equipment during power outages or out in the field. Strategic Relocation, 3rd edition by Joel Skousen. When Disaster Strikes by Matthew Stein. TheraSafe, used by Homeland Security to protect yourself during any radiological event. Hand crank shortwave AM/FM radios. Everything that we've researched and found to be the best is available at InfoWarsShop.com, and your purchase makes our InfoWar possible. We're getting prepared. Are you? InfoWarsShop.com.
In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented, a 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield Nascent Iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield Nascent Iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Klayman, who is successfully suing the NSA and having victories and being demonized by CNN, is scheduled to join us here in about 5 minutes. He got delayed in traffic, so he's coming up in a few minutes. Then we're going to have live on-the-street reports from Leanne McAdoo out there in front of the Texas State Capitol, where, by the way, I see Karl Rove's on national TV in front of the Capitol right now. I know that studio. He's actually in a studio right by the Capitol. So maybe they can catch Karl Rove while they're out there on the street. That's not their primary mission, but they could ask him about his nickname and ask him about how he's trying to destroy the libertarian movement in the Republican Party. But we're going to be down there talking about the attack on Christmas, the attack on the First Amendment, the fact that Texas had to pass a law that you can display Christmas trees and things like that. Doesn't matter. Schools are still pulling them and telling kids in Texas that you can't hand out Christian cards that talk about Christ or even Noel. Separation of church and state means that the school can't have an official religion and make you practice it. As a valedictorian, you can get up and say that you want to thank God or Muhammad or nobody. It's your First Amendment. You can get up and talk about in your acceptance speech how you like to surf or how you like to cook. It's your speech. It's your victory speech. It's your speech to be remembered by. And they're telling them at football proms, at homecoming speeches, the king and queen of the class, at the graduation speeches, do not mention God. Do not thank God at the end of a football game when you get asked by the local paper who you want to thank or what you think. Well, I want to thank God for protecting me and not getting any injuries. Oh, my gosh, they've had people that have talked to a newspaper have been kicked off the team for a game. That's how whacked out political correctness is with these teachers and these coaches and these governments literally thinking with political correctness that everything's illegal or everything's wrong. It's not. It's like in San Antonio. It was a predominantly Hispanic team playing another Hispanic team. Most I saw the kids on the TV. It was very few of them were black or white. It was mainly Hispanic basketball team against another Hispanic basketball team from closer to the border. And the more liberal team, because San Antonio is very conservative, were chanting USA, USA, because that's just kind of the mindless chant people do at sports games now when their basketball team won. And it was a big thing. It was... came out a few months ago. They're like, whoa, this is evil. I mean, this is racist. There were kids chanting USA. Everything's offensive. Call somebody fat, Hunger Games star says you need to be arrested. Here's Morgan's come out and said, hey, it's good. We need to restrict the free speech. He said, Piers Morgan, First Amendment, quote, shouldn't protect vile bigots like Phil Robertson. See, he wants all your rights, not just the Second Amendment. He wants... the 4th, 10th, 1st, all of it gone. And again, we have a clip here I'm going to play in a moment. Piers Morgan, in the last few days, has been having votes on the CNN website. They've closed the voting now for who you think was the most memorable guest or moment in the year. And his show doesn't matter unless you are the big moment that got picked up all the other TV shows. His show has a tiny audience. Ours is much bigger on record. He barely has a 500,000 viewers total. I mean, that is pathetic, folks. Larry King used to have 10 million more than a decade ago. And then when they got rid of him, it was like 2.5, 3 million. And then it plunged after that down to less than a 500,000 for Piers Morgan on an average night. I mean, it is in the tank. And Piers Morgan, when I was on, still had about 600,000, 700,000 viewers. In a year, he's gone down to below 500,000. And they admitted 2 million viewers that night. The next night, he had a ratings jump of still over a million. And for 2 weeks was over a million because I was on his show. And they could talk about the aftermath. I mean, it was on every comedy show, Jay Leno, you name it. It was on foreign news. I mean, that is one of the top media events of the year. And it was simply someone saying, you want to enslave us and take our guns, and if you try it, 1776 will commence again. Is that clear? Stop lying. Stop acting like it's about kids. Everywhere you people are in control, you take all the guns except for the state. It's about a monopoly of power. Dianne Feinstein says, Mrs. and Miss America, if I can get the votes, we're going to ban your guns. Stop saying it isn't about banning guns. Here in New York City, guns are banned, except for the very wealthy that have bodyguards or politically connected who are able to get the concealed carries. This is a form of discrimination. We have a right to defend ourselves. And that was so shocking. I mean, Paul Revere, folks, went around and said, get your guns, kill people. And they were like, oh, that's an American patriot. Because the British were coming to take the guns. All I say is, don't try to take our guns. And even mainline conservatives at first were like, oh my gosh, it's so mean. Oh my gosh, it's so aggressive. He discredits us. Well, then go ahead and chop your huevos off and mail them into Piers Morgan. Or mail them into Obama. Because if that's the way you think, and that's how pathetic you've gotten, that I am a wimp compared to founding fathers. People like Thomas Paine, people like George Washington, people like Alexander Hamilton. I mean, I am a milquetoast, limp-wristed wimp. And you people think I'm a big, mean, fire-breathing dragon for telling some usurper foreigner that they're going to get our guns. And I told him, listen here, redcoat. We know what you're up to. And you notice it's voted the number one thing on his show. And I'll guarantee you, number one on CNN. I mean, I looked at the numbers, folks. That's the biggest thing Piers Morgan's ever done in his life. And I've now challenged Piers Morgan. I've now challenged him on Infowars.com. And guess who tops Piers Morgan's 10 most memorable moments of 2013 for them to have me back on. And it's not that I need to get back on his show. It'll be big that I go back on. CNN called the other day and wanted me on, and I said, watch, the higher-ups will say no, I'm not worried about it. Talking about, you know, do I think Santa Claus is white, comment on Megyn Kelly. And I said, they're not going to call back. There's a standing order to not have me on. The lower levels always call me, and then it gets countermanded. And listen, I'll do it taped. I'll do it with my hands tied behind my back, wimp. And I'll go on and just give you an intellectual, deadpan interview. And that'll be newsworthy that last year it was like this. This time he was on Valium. You know, that'll be the joke. I'm ready to come on and intellectually, right now, I'm ready to have you on right now, Piers Morgan. Here's Piers Morgan last night talking about the number one thing on his show in 2013.
Okay, well, we now have a drum roll. This is number one. This was the as voted for by viewers all day long on Twitter and other social media, on the internet. Mm-hmm. This is the single most popular clip from my show of the year, and I think it plays very well to the main theme of the show this year, too. Let's watch this.
Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. Doesn't matter how many lemmings you get out there on the street begging for them to have their guns taken. We will not relinquish them. Do you understand? That's why you're going to fail, and the establishment knows, no matter how much propaganda, the Republic will rise again when you attempt to take our guns.
Please,
Piers Morgan, I'm a crazy gun nut. If you just let me keep talking, Piers Morgan, the world will know I'm a crazy gun nut. You don't have to ask me tough questions. I'll just keep talking to everybody and know.
The scary thing is to know that that guy has a gun and probably has several guns.
Okay, well, we now have a drum roll.
That's it. So, oh my gosh, I have a gun. And on the same show, a week after I was on, they said they're going to dress Piers up with a gun to kill me. And he said, yes, I want to kill him. I mean, they're just a bunch of mental patients. So there you go, the guy making fun of somebody standing up for his rights, just like I do for the First Amendment, 10th Amendment, 4th Amendment. And then Larry Klayman stands up for people's rights, and CNN demonizes him as well. So we need to go to CNN. We need to go to Piers Morgan's Twitter. I need to tweet him during the break. I've forgotten to do that and say, hey, come on, go read my article at Infowars.com. I promise. Well, I've already talked to Piers Morgan before. We're going to play that later. I got a tip he was going to be at a gun range a few months after this outside Houston. And so I went down there and walked in and got a chance to talk to him. And I gave them my word. I said, I will be nice to him since they called me if you let me go talk to him. And I went and I was polite. I'm a man of my word. Unless he slaps me in the face or something, which is the kind of thing he'd do, maybe, I'm joking, then I'll be friendly. So Piers Morgan has no excuse, but they're afraid, folks. So I bet they don't have me back on, even though they get record ratings. This isn't about ratings, it's about control. Now, speaking of control, we're going to play the clip in a moment. We're going to skip this network break. Larry Klayman, who has had the only victory against the NSA's open destruction of the Fourth Amendment and violation of all of our privacy and robbing us in our homes of our liberty and of our basic freedoms. Larry Klayman, the famous icon of liberty, a constitutional lawyer, has had so many victories, gotten so many government documents out on North American Union, on Clinton, you name it, always being demonized. CNN rolled a piece, it's a six-minute piece, it's up on Infowars.com, saying that Larry Klayman just wants attention and is a magpie and is a gadfly and this doesn't matter and he's a bad guy and such and such called him an idiot. And so they had this incredibly slanted yellow journalism piece that they rolled into him. Then they brought him up and had a couple people gang up on him, the host. And when he said, how dare you carry the water for Obama? This is all Americans losing our right, which we need to come together against the illegal spying. And they just started saying, cut him off, cut him off. But then the producers knew it would look bad. They had to wait till they went to commercial, like with me with Piers Morgan. So they didn't cut him off, and it blew up in their face. And even Politico, that is a Democratic Party operation, had to admit it. It literally looked bad for CNN. And we're going to play a short clip of that in a moment. But I wanted to get him on because this ties into Duck Dynasty. It ties into Piers Morgan saying, censor Duck Dynasty, censor anyone that has free speech. They're openly arresting preachers in Canada that read out of the Bible and criticize homosexuality. And folks, I don't get into this issue. But the point is I will fight for people's rights to be gay or to not be. And I'm sick of them promoting it in schools. I don't want them promoting any sex in schools. And I'm getting really sick of the gay mafia because they really are out of control and dominating the culture and trying to force this stuff down our throats. And I don't like it. I don't want Dom Perignon and the finest filet mignon forced down my throat. Okay, so I don't like being a slave. And so I'll get Larry Klayman's brief take on that as well. But first off, wow, this CNN thing, sir, really blew up in their face. And the demonization of you and your legal team across the board in all the comments, in all the major socialist newspapers, is really blowing up. And the left, the grassroots left, really doesn't like seeing you be attacked because you've been very eloquent in standing up for our speech. How do they turn you a hero into a zero? I don't think they can do it, Larry Klayman.
Alex, you know, that's the formula that they use, is that when they don't want you to get oxygen. And obviously this was the biggest victory, I think, perhaps in the history against government abuse. And they couldn't stand it that we did it. I mean, obviously, if the ACLU had done it, there would have been a parade. But they're worried about our other cases about Obama. And what's this? You know, Lemon is a very pro-Obama, ultra-leftist. Tubman was very pro-Clinton. I fought him during the Clinton years. So, you know, it was a hit piece, and it's as simple as that. They try to take you down a notch. So you're not as effective, you know, in terms of fundraising or whatever else you may do. And that's the formula that they use. This obviously came out of the White House and or the Democratic National Committee or both. And, you know, we saw the result.
Well, you're right. And for those that didn't see the clip, we're not going to play the whole thing. We'll play a short clip in a moment. I mean, the hit piece they rolled, the special report before it, I mean, they basically claim you sunk the Titanic. I mean, you're a bad guy.
You know, the funny thing is, as I pointed out on that interview, is that I actually got a lot of accolades from the left, you know, after that decision came out, because this is an issue that doesn't cut across different political lines, Ellen. And the reality is, this is for all America, and that's what I pointed out in that interview. This is a victory for the United States. This is a victory for the American people. This is a victory for anybody that believes in liberty. Anyone that believes in keeping the government off your back so they can't destroy you because we've become a police state. So, you know, it spoke for itself. Now, you know, anybody who's seen Don Lemon, it's always a sarcastic remark about conservatives or libertarians or about Republicans. And as far as Jeffrey Toobin is concerned, those in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. Do a Google search. A couple years ago, he was hauled into court because he impregnated Jeff Greenfield's daughter at CBS, and he was married at the time. So this is a guy that claims, you know, great ethics and great morality. And in terms of Lemon has made certain statements. You can find him out there. He said, well, only I know my political affiliation. Well, there are quotes, and we're going to, you know, be issuing a press release on this where he disparages, you know, fat old white guys in the Republican Party. And goes on. It's actually much worse than
sure,
that.
Sure, I can't even watch him when I see him on. He's so pretentious. He is just drips with propaganda and arrogance. Another out-of-control lying narcissist.
Well, yeah. You know, and I didn't want to pick a fight. I went over there. I was invited. And you invite somebody like that to a lynching, you know, that's just low class, very low class. But I knew what they were going to do because in the beginning we were in the green room. I was in there with my chief of staff, and we saw, you know, the trailer come on with me giving the speech in front of the World War II Memorial, talking about Obama bowing down to Allah. Franklin, I don't back off that. He does. And he favors Muslim interests over American and Israeli interests. That's not even a dispute. But we knew that it was likely to be something, but I didn't expect it to that extent. And, you know, the story was, who is Larry Klayman? Not, what about the NSA? And that tells you everything. But, you know, I've been going through this throughout my career, Alex. You go through it. I mean, they attack you similarly and others who stand for something. And you can't be deterred. And our founding fathers were called all kinds of names by the Tories. Their lives were threatened. There were bounties on their heads. And I'm willing to lay it on the line. This decision that we got, and I'm not just saying it because I got it, by the grace of God, and it's just one little part of our second American Revolution, and I believe the decision will hold up. But it was a remarkable decision. It was probably the strongest decision ever issued against the government, because never has there been a violation of constitutional rights of this magnitude, and the stakes are extremely high. So you can expect, you know, this kind of reaction. But it's interesting, if you see what's out there on YouTube, because the clip is up. I don't know if the full clip is up, because when CNN put it up, they took the lead in and they took it out, because that was the really defamatory part that was coming in. They don't show that. They want me to look like I'm attacking them.
Absolutely. And I want to just remind people how big this ruling is for the NSA, and the fact that the judge said, you know, this looks exactly like Fourth Amendment violation. The suit's going forward. And then he excoriated the NSA, saying the emperor has no clothes, saying what we all know. And you're saying we're in a police state. And now you've got the highest level NSA whistleblower ever coming out saying, you're right, we're in a serious police state. And I mean, you're just saying black is black, white is white, up is up, down is down, left is left, right is right, 2 + 2 = 4. And in the age of Common Core, they're saying it equals 5. And as George Orwell said, telling the truth in a tyranny, in a world of universal deceit, telling the truth is a revolutionary act. So you're a revolutionary. And, yeah. and we stand with you. And it just shows who the media is, that across the so-called liberal media, they've been trying to demonize you. But how does this dovetail with the Duck Dynasty situation? Regardless of what we think about lifestyles, they're now saying, you know, Piers Morgan is saying you don't have a First Amendment. I mean, these people are really authoritarians. And Camille Paglia says they're fascist and ultra-Stalinist. I agree. What do you say?
Well, I say that it's black or white, Alex. It doesn't take to be, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to figure out the government has all of everybody's metadata, 300 plus million people. And that's why the judge's decision was so simple and easy to reach. He had courage to do it because most judges wouldn't do it. Most judges would shy away because they know that when they make a strong decision, they may never be appointed to a higher position. They make themselves radioactive. Now, I have to take my hat off to this judge. I've seen very few in my career that had this courage. And if you read the decision, it's almost identical to what I argued in front of him on November 18th. And you can see that transcript at freedomwatchusa.org. This judge accepted what I said, and what I told him was, the judge, you're the last century. You're the last hope of the American people to stave off a revolution. If you don't act, if you don't stop this NSA spying on all Americans and the coercion and the enslavement and the intimidation, then the people are going to be in the streets, ultimately. And this is the worst violation of constitutional rights in American history. We are not the Soviet Union. We are not China. We are the United States of America. And when you read the judge's decision, and again, you can find it at freedomwatchusa.org, you'll see that he quotes Madison and founding fathers. And this is a great judge, and there are very few in this country. I would say 99% of the judges in this country would not have done what he did. He's an American hero.
I agree with you. Now, expanding on this, I'm not trying to rope you into the whole Duck Dynasty controversy, but separately, where do you stand with the so-called left always trying to shut down free speech, the establishment left? I mean, they are really moving on every front to take down Christmas trees, crosses, to anybody that mildly criticizes somebody's lifestyle, to get them kicked off the air. They wanted to shut your mic off because you wanted to defend yourself after they demonized you. I mean, I think we should stop calling them liberals or progressives. These people are really kleptocratic con artists.
No, they're leftists. I never call them liberals because, I'm in Europe, liberal means conservative. They're leftists, ultra-leftists. And Klayman, wears it on his sleeve. Klayman is a racist, okay? You could see that. And the reality is, you take a look at some of his comments about fat white people in the Republican Party, he grounded into me. And that's the reality. It's about time that we start talking clearly on the other side. I believe in civil rights. I'm a civil rights lawyer. That's what I am, in effect. And I believe that all people, as Jefferson wrote, are created equal. Okay, but you know what? Conservatives are not equal anymore. Okay, we're at the back of the bus. And we're taking a beating. But you know what? We have to put our neck out. We can't be scared. And we have to do what we have to do. And like our founding fathers, it takes risking our lives. We have to do it, Alex. You know, and I'm not afraid.
You're right. Larry Klayman, good job. FreedomWatchUSA.org, linked up on Infowars.com. Thanks for popping in with us, and great job standing up to that censorship. You absolutely beat them.
Thank you, Alex. God bless.
God bless you. Have a great Christmas. All right, we're going to come back, hit some more breaking news, and then we're going to have our reporters on the street in Austin, Texas, Leanne McAdoo, and Jakari's also out there, Jakari Jackson, talking to folks about the attack on free speech.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Strategic relocation is a systematic way to think strategically in the future about how do I safeguard.
Renowned author and expert Joel Skousen.
The U.S. isn't building huge underground bases and bunkers because of some terrorist threat. They know that a massive nuclear attack is coming. They want that attack to come.
Joel Skousen is renowned as one of the world's foremost experts in strategic relocation and the securing of your home.
What I tell people is that you do have time. We talk about natural disasters, the health environment. We talk about pollution, the water quality. My personal experience about being in every one of these states, most people won't even be ready and won't be able to get out of town because there'll be absolute panic.
There is no preparedness without strategy. This Christmas, give the gift of preparedness. Strategic Relocation, the film, with Joel Skousen and Alex Jones. Available only at InfoWarsShop.com. Or by calling 888-253-3139.
You are listening to an InfoWars.com frontline report. It's Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, and breaking up at InfoWars.com from a Hollywood reporter. It's also up on DrudgeReport.com. They say they will walk Duck Dynasty family. We cannot imagine the show without Phil Robertson, and they will walk. And there's a photo of them with a bunch of chemtrails in the background. Part of the weather modification project that's declassified and going on, but nobody will talk about. That story is up on Infowars.com and is up on DrudgeReport.com. And then up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, new Facebook page, Boycott A&E Support Free Speech. We've launched that new Facebook page. And then that way, folks, we can really tell people what's going on with the anti-free speech agenda. It's not just a gay agenda being promoted. It's setting the precedent to ban people's free speech in the name of civil rights. It's an absolute abomination. Now, there's another one out there that got launched yesterday. We should have thought of this. I should have thought of this. It has over 1 million likes. We've got 2,517. We've got over 2 million likes on our other Facebook pages. Got more than 15 of them. One of them's got 600, almost 700,000. We need everybody to go over and like this so it gets out to everybody, because ours points out what Camille Paglia properly said, and I think puts out even more First Amendment information than the one that's got the 1 million likes, which, again, I'm glad it's out there. We just want to really have a page to educate people and bring them into the deeper knowledge of what this agenda is about. Because if they can ban Christmas trees and not let preachers, you know, speak out against homosexuality, then there's no free speech for anybody. And we point out, if they can ban the Bible in Canada, as they're now doing for preachers preaching from, reading from Leviticus, and actually have the Leviticus quote here with me, we can put it on screen, then they can ban the Quran. It says the same thing. So this is the type of situation that we're talking about, and it's InfoWars Free Speech on Facebook, or you can follow the link at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. So it is essential. We ought to bomb Google with a Google bomb, though they've got algorithms to block this now. We can still do it. Just how about free speech? Everybody types free speech into the Google search engine over and over and over and over again, and make that the top term. So that they get led back to everybody that's talking about free speech, because that is a unifying situation across the board. But this is a Twitter bomb and a Facebook bomb, and we need your help to make it successful. Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.com. Go get the article, new Facebook page, Boycott A&E, Support Free Speech. Get it and send it out on your Twitter, retweet it from Real Alex Jones, get it out to everyone you know. It is absolutely essential. Now, again, also, they say the most popular voted on CNN thing of the year on Piers Morgan was when I was on the show. And it's now seen by even major gun groups as an iconic moment where the gauntlet was thrown down and go, look, you want to enslave us? The government still got the guns, and if you try to take them, it's going to cause a revolution. Back off. And many analysts, they've had articles mark that point in the week after that when they began to lose the gun battle. It isn't about the kids. Gun crime's down. You know it. You want to enslave us. Doesn't matter how many lemmings you brainwash. We're not turning them in. We will not relinquish them. And that's how we got to respond to these people. They tell you be timid, lie down, that it discredits you if you're angry and focused and dominant. No. But then they're angry and focused and dominant. When the cops come up and say, don't protest, disperse, they talk like they're in charge. The system talks like it's in charge. It wants you to be a beta, submissive to its illegitimate tyranny. And it's time to be alpha, or you will be a slave. The only person we should be subservient to is God. And again, some of you atheists and folks don't have a God, so it's materialism or yourself or the state. Most atheists I know, my biggest beef with it is the state becomes your God. Well, it's not my God. And you can knock my religion all day, but at least I follow what my ancestors followed. At least I've got some continuity. At least what I follow built modern civilization. You can knock it all day. At least I got something. What do you got? You don't know anything about what's happening. We only see a very narrow spectrum of light. We only perceive a micron of reality. The science now proves this. Most scientists, genetic engineers, dark matter, astronomers are now becoming religious. And I've had my own personal experiences, ladies and gentlemen, that I don't talk about. It's like the Fleetwood Mac song. Yeah, here they come, the crystal visions. I keep my visions to myself. People have no idea what's going on in the real world, how real all this is. How do you know when you're out, you can be standing in your own kitchen window facing a backyard of a empty house that hadn't been sold yet, and you feel somebody looking at you, and you look up, and there's a meter reader for some reason staring right at you, and they've made that connection, their soul to your soul, and you pick up on it. I can tell you how many times, probably happened 3 or 4 times, that I've been on our own huge family ranch that, you know, thousands of acres that we've had for since 1829, when this was Mexico, Mexican land grant, and I'll be out there. It's happened 3 or 4 times in the middle of nowhere, in when it's not even deer season. There's no one out there. I mean, we're not talking about fields, folks. The property we have left, stuff that hadn't been sold off over the years to pay bills and debts, and people get cancer or whatever, or, you know, families have more sons and they want a piece of it and they sell it, is pretty much woods. It's wild. And you'll be out in the middle of nowhere, and I'll just feel somebody looking at me and turn and walk through the woods and through an opening and up in a tree. Some guy has got spikes on his feet and is 60 feet up in the air going, "Hey, how's it going?" I'm like, you're number one, you're poaching. Number two, it's not even deer season. And number three, we don't have any people leasing this right now. Who are you? Oh, I thought I was on. Yeah, you thought wrong. You crossed the fence. I'm going to turn around and I'm going to leave. And I'm going to come back in about 10 minutes. And if you're still up there, I'm going to call the game warden or worse. And then the guy goes, okay, and leaves. And that happened a couple other times where poachers have come in. And then another time, somebody was bow hunting on our property out front, because we've got some acreage out front, the ranch house. Most of our land's a couple of miles away. And I was out there with a rifle. Bow season was earlier. And walking through the woods on the edge of a big cow pasture, and felt somebody looking at me. And the fence is right there to some family of mine that owns the property next to it. And I felt somebody looking at me back in the woods. And I went back, went through, big oak tree. Guy up there going, "Hey, man, what are you doing? I'm paying to be here. I'm bow hunting. Who are you?" And I'm like, "Oh, that's my cousin's property. I just felt somebody looking at me." They're like, "Yeah, I know. I can feel that too sometimes. I was watching you out there." One time I rode a four-wheeler out when I was about 12. Had stolen some of my grandmother's cigarettes. And that's another time I just remembered, and I felt somebody looking at me. And again, folks, that's just a very small part of it. I'm going to leave it at that. I'll tell you what most of you have experienced. I'm not going to let the media try to discredit me with other stuff, but it's pretty interesting, to say the least. But there's a lot going on, like they say in Master and Commander, where you know, the Jonas throws himself overboard, and suddenly the wind comes back, and he looks over and he says, "The doctor, there's a lot going on that isn't in your books." And he's paraphrasing another Shakespearean play. I forget the exact quote, but there's a lot happening. Now, they went out there, and it's usually crawling downtown around the Capitol in that area. And it's lunchtime, so there should be people out there. And we do Man on the Street sometimes live on air. We're going to be doing this more. But there's no one out there. It is a ghost town with Jakari Jackson and Leanne McAdoo. But I'm going to have them go downtown and do some interviews about, hey, do you think schools banning Christmas trees and not letting kids hand out their own Christmas cards is right? When they say, "Yeah, I do," or "No, I don't," say, "Well, why?" When they say, "I do," you know, separation of church and state, go, wait, the church, there can't be one church over the school and one official religion. That wouldn't be freedom. But you can go with a Christmas card and give it to anybody. You could be a Satanist and give somebody a card saying, "Please come to our Church of Satan meetings. All the drugs and sex you can handle, but we want to abuse you and use you." You know what I mean? I mean, the whole issue here is this is tyranny in the name of civil liberties. And it ties into the Duck Dynasty. It ties into the NSA. It ties into the persecution of the press. It ties into internet censorship, the fairness doctrine, all of it. But they will get some Man on the Street and have it on the nightly news tonight that Leanne McAdoo is hosting. And we take you now to Leanne, who's also...
Hi, Alex.
And you're wearing a Christmas cape there, to be politically incorrect. And you're there with a Jakari who's got a red tie. That's offensive, because that could be...
I don't have an earpiece.
That could be associated with... Well, she can ask questions for me, because I know Jakari wasn't going to be live with us. But since there's nobody down there, we'll have him be interviewed by Leanne. Leanne, give us your take on the criminal, offensive Christmas tree that is behind you that we had to get a state law passed just to be able to have in front of the Capitol. I mean, that is so evil, so nasty, so bad. I want you guys to walk over after you talk and actually give us an up close, you know, because I mean, this is a talisman of wickedness and hate speech. Of course, there's a goddess, you know, the real god of that Capitol, Eulogia, or is it Diana, is up on top of the Capitol. But what is your take, Leanne, out there today on the attack on Christmas?
Well, obviously, the Christmas tree behind me, you can see it is extremely evil. They've erected it behind me, and they actually just started playing some demonic music from the tree. I heard it. It was
Christmas carols. Yeah.
It was a Christmas carol. I heard it. Jingle Bells, I believe, was the tune, and extremely offensive. But that's why I wanted to come out here today dressed as St. Nicholas to just express my gratitude to the state for granting me the privilege to express my First Amendment right to practice freedom of religion and, you know, wear Christmas colors.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, through the fields we go, laughing all the way.
Oh my gosh, that's terrorism.
Singing voice.
Absolutely. Ask Shikari his take on the thought crime he's involved in.
Do you feel okay with all this thought crime that you're involved in out here on the street?
No, I mean, because Jesus is the reason for the season. And as much as I don't really like Rick Perry, you know, he's forcing Gardasil on little girls and calling it the law, he at least said that you can call Christmas Christmas. So I give him credit where credit is due. But just to say that you're involved in a thought crime for wanting to celebrate Christmas, or if you want to stand up for your religious beliefs and, you know, they want to demonize you for that, that's completely wrong.
Yeah, exactly. It's our right. It's our First Amendment right. So why did we need to go pass legislation and get permission from the government to allow us to do this without the threat of being sued for wearing red or green at school or giving Christmas cards out or candy canes to your friends? It's ridiculous.
Well, I tell you, I don't know. Piers Morgan, he says the First Amendment shouldn't protect vile bigots like Phil Robertson. I thought the First Amendment protected everybody as long as you didn't call for violence against somebody.
Well, I mean, it's there, but you've got to have explicit permission from the government. I mean, they have to then say, yes.
Hey, there's a lady right behind you. Go talk to her. Wave her over.
Excuse me.
Say, ma'am, hi.
Hi, ma'am.
No. We're going to talk to her. Let me talk to her. Say, hello.
Having a language.
Je ne comprends pas.
No, don't. Well, tell her, come here. Tell her, I am La Patrona. Tell her, you are La Patrona. Say, I am mucho.
I am La Patrona.
Say, I am La Patrona El Queenie.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, wave some folks over.
How do you feel about the fact that they are not allowing Christmas trees in school, or if you try to bring candy canes or cards to your friends, that you are going to get suspended?
I have no comment. Merry Christmas.
Good minion. Good minion.
Visiting by Krampus. You're going to get a visit from Krampus this year, and you're okay with that?
I don't know what that is.
That is Santa's dark twin. And he's going to bring you some coal.
He's the one that really brings the coal.
I'm sorry.
Merry Christmas.
There I go.
God, he's looking at you like you're like, I just saw that. People that talk. I just saw fellow humans that talk. I got one that can see. Sorry, go ahead.
I did not realize the power of the St. Nicholas robe. It is just too much for these people out here.
I think they are intimidated by the fact that they do know it's Christmas, so you're wearing Santa Claus colors. Why don't you take it off, Leanne, so you don't scare them so bad, and then go across the street here in a minute, and I mean, just literally go over to folks and say, hi, Merry Christmas. Is it okay to say Merry Christmas? Because we want to see if the sheeple are able to talk to us. Ask Shikari what he thought of that guy looking like a deer in the headlights.
What do you think about that guy? Did he look like a deer in the headlights, or...?
He was a little surprised. I'm sure, you know, when you see somebody in a robe like this, so you're not exactly sure what you're going to get asked. But he did acknowledge Christmas, so that's
Hey, wave those people over across the street. There's people. Pan around. I know there's victims out there.
We're going to go talk to these fellas.
Absolutely. Let's do it. I mean, come on.
Merry Christmas. Are you gentlemen offended by my use of the term?
No.
Someone just called me a terrorist. That man just called
me. Oh, my gosh.
It is real. So when did America become the Soviet Union? We were actually just granted the privilege to practice our First Amendment right of freedom of religion and stuff by allowing the Christmas tree and Christmas colors. Do you think that's just insane?
We're from Canada.
What happens here.
Well, I mean, ask him if they're allowed to have it in Canada.
Are you allowed to celebrate Christmas freely in Canada, or do you have to ask permission?
No, our charter guarantees religious freedom. You can basically do whatever you want. Of course, we only got a constitution in 1982, so, you know, ours is pretty young still. We were a little bit more modern when we drafted it. You guys are still working on the, you know, 1860 copy.
Yeah.
1982 was, you know.
Yeah, they're continually trying to rewrite it.
Ours is the model, dummy.
Ours is the model. And what do you think about that? Children here in school aren't being allowed to wear red or green or bring candy canes to their friends.
Is this a joke?
Oh, no, that's real. We just had to actually...
Talking about the Christmas cards. Not allowed. Evil.
Not allowed to have Christmas cards or Christmas carols. And our governor just signed legislation called the Merry Christmas Law. That'll protect us from being sued for being out here and offending people.
I don't know. It's different in Canada. You're allowed to do that stuff. You wouldn't be allowed to... You can't have school prayer in public schools. I don't know if you guys allow that. We don't allow, like...
Explain to him that they're violating individual prayer.
But that's really just, as far as that goes, is school prayer, really. But you can bring Christmas cards or anything, and we usually celebrate, like, try to do a Jewish thing.
Yeah, right. Well, we do that here, too. But it's basically like as the school can't say, hey, you've got to say this prayer or do that. But you as an individual can freely pray or do whatever
And they're trying to ban that.
They're trying to ban that. Obviously, for certain religions, specifically Christianity, they're not going to tell someone who practices, you know, Islam that they can't go and practice their religion 4 or 5 times a day. What do you think about that?
Yeah, this whole thing is just wacky, pretty much. Yeah.
The Canadians have spoken. Thanks, guys.
All right, great job, Canadians. Well, looks like they think more freely than the average Soviet. We're going to go to break, but real fast, and then find some more folks to talk to. Jakari, what's your take on those men?
What's your take on the meeting?
Well, I'm glad to see that these guys, are at least aware of this now. And they said, you know, it's completely ridiculous. They couldn't believe that this actually happened. They said, is this a joke? They couldn't believe it. And, you know, just like they were saying that they have freedom of religion, we do too, in theory, you know, but, you know, you have to ask permission to practice your religion.
That's right. We're going to exercise our rights so they can't take them, period. They're a bunch of authoritarian scum, and we are going to get back in their face and not be henpecked and nudged.
You've spent precious time and money preparing for emergencies. Your generator is good to go. You have plenty of extra fuel stored, but you're never truly ready without PRI fuel stabilizers. More than half of generator failures occur because the fuel has gone bad. PRI fuel stabilizers keep your fuel fresh and keep you ready for any disaster. That's why the pros rely on it and why you need it. Call 888-776-9373 or visit priproducts.com for the dealer nearest you.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to generate an endless supply of natural silver solutions, silverlungs.com. You'll find no wild claims or pseudoscience, just a lifetime of nano-sized pure silver solutions. The Silver Lungs generator allows you to make your own, so stop paying for silver solutions. The unique lung delivery system targets respiratory infections where other silver solutions simply cannot reach. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
You better watch out, you sure better cry. You're at least gonna pout, and I'm telling you why. Privacy is leaving your town.
Is your cell phone being used to build a profile on you? Give the gift of privacy and block unwanted cell phone spying with the Privacy Case from privacycase.com.
They're making their list, they're checking them twice. They're gonna make up who's been naughty or nice.
The problem is real, and so is the solution. Go to privacycase.com because...
They see you when you're sleeping. They listen when you're awake. They can tell us all you've been bad when you've been good. So get yourself a privacy case.
Now through December 31st, buy yourself an American-made privacy case and give one for only $79.95 each. Go to privacycase.com today. The Privacy Case, because there is a case for privacy.
By now, you may know that a Bitcoin is the first decentralized currency that's easily transferred from person to person over the internet. No bank needed. This means lower fees and accounts can never be frozen, limited, or closed. Plus, a large number of businesses and merchants already accept Bitcoins, and Bitcoins are easily exchanged for dollars, euros, and more. If you're interested in making money in the Bitcoin market right away, and by right away we mean start making money today, please visit us at cloudhashing.com. Cloudhashing.com is one of the fastest growing Bitcoin miners in the world, delivering the highest profits to people just like you. To get started, join us at cloudhashing.com and you will start mining Bitcoins right away and get paid daily. You heard correctly. You will receive payments every single day. And the best part? You do not need a computer or need any experience in mining Bitcoins. It's perfect for everyone. Learn more at cloudhashing.com. Just like it sounds, cloudhashing.com. Start making money today at cloudhashing.com.
Everybody knows we've got control freak authoritarians. But you get called racist if you don't want to go along with it. But it doesn't work anymore. Everyone needs to stop bowing down. The Southern Poverty Law Center comes out and demonizes states that don't ban guns and gives them a bad grade, and the media covers it like it's important. That's because the media is a bunch of toolboxes. Briefly, we are listener supported, and all your purchases are supported at InfoWarsStore.com, and the books, the videos, the Patriot apparel supports the broadcast. High quality storable foods are at InfoWarsStore.com from My Patriot Supply. We've got it all right there on the site. High quality dash cams branded to InfoWars so you can protect yourself. The Made in 1776 line. We've got the Survival Shield Nascent Iodine, and in a double size bottle. For only $10 more, we have the fluoride shield that has five other compounds to detoxify your body on record inside of it to supercharge it. So our best deal is the fluoride shield in the 2-ounce bottle, completely organic, all the compounds, extremely expensive for us to get all these. We cut no corners on the quality, and it's double the strength of the leading competitor. And no one has a fluoride shield detoxifier cleanser like this that literally just synergizes everything with the synergy. You can also call toll-free 888-253-3139. And if you order today, you might get it before Christmas, but probably not. But regardless, you can still give gift subscriptions to the magazines, and then they'll get it after Christmas, the next 12 issues. Just put their address in, buy them a gift subscription to InfoWars Magazine that we sell at cost. You can also give them a PrisonPlanet.tv membership to see the nightly news, all the films, and support the media operation. $5.95 a month, and 11 people can use the membership. So give yourself a membership, or renew your membership, or buy a second membership, and send folks e-cards. Don't fight all the traffic getting last-minute Christmas presents. You can just send e-cards with a username passcode that's unique that you make for the site, and then your friends and family can go and see the nightly news and so much more. Great way to give the gift of awakening. So again, Jakari Jackson and Leanne McAdoo are now across the street, right in front of the Capitol, at the terrorist tree, the bigot tree. And Leanne, you've got some folks there to talk to. Do you want to apologize to people for being by the terror tree?
I just asked this gentleman, and he told me that he's Jewish, and he isn't offended by this Christmas tree.
Oh, really? Well,
I find it very nice. Yeah.
Because it's a free country, right? What do you think about here in America? They are not allowing kids to go to school dressed in red or green. They can't bring Christmas cards. They're banning it from schools.
Yeah, well, I'm good either way. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Yeah. If I've been asked, I'm fine with that, yes.
Yes. Uh-huh. Okay, see, there you have it. They are not terrorized by this Christmas tree. It is not a frightening thing here.
Ask his wife if she's got anything to say.
Do you have anything to say about the state of...
It's a free country. Everybody can do whatever they want to.
We're in California.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, awesome.
It's a free country here.
All right, there you go. I mean, everybody recognizes this is tyranny. I mean, if I was in a Muslim country and they were having a holiday, I wouldn't say, change that, I'm offended. And you can say, well, we're a country of everything. Yeah, but Christmas, if you're going to have it, it is Christmas. Leanne, will you please have Josh show us the terrorist tree, please?
Yes. Here behind me, you can see it's extraordinarily offensive.
And, of course, now you're marching towards the Capitol itself that has Masonic regalia all over it. And everybody better be careful, or they're going to make everybody take that down as well. I wonder if folks know what a woman holding a star, that's actually the goddess Columbia up there, what they think of that religious iconography. Leanne, what do you think of the goddess up there?
Well, I think she's, you know, I think she's pretty beautiful, but I don't know the whole background of it. So,
are you offended by her?
You know, at times I think she's holding the star above the tree, which is kind of reminiscent to how they'll have, you know, the other angels holding the star above the tree. So that's probably offensive. They should probably take that down.
That's right. We need to sign a petition to have them actually take it down and break it in little pieces. No, actually, it just means good luck. The guardian goddess over things. Stay there. I want to come back and get Jakari's take as well with you, Leanne. Stay there. Built by the Capitol. Thanks.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
My
friends, Alex Jones here to tell you about some of the most important information concerning you and your family's health. Radiation levels have more than doubled in the last 60 years in the Northern Hemisphere from all of the nuclear testing and radiological accidents. Radioactive contamination is now in most of the food supply. There's only two ways to avoid this. Move south of the equator or properly protect your thyroid with nascent iodine. Looking to protect my family, I've done deep research. Nascent iodine is the purest, cleanest, absolute best form of iodine to protect yourself and your family. It's made right here in the USA, completely non-GMO. I searched out the best quality and now have developed a double-strength form of nascent iodine, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Nascent iodine is on record as one of the only safe ways to detox from fluoride poisoning. Survival Shield Nascent Iodine. Secure your super high-quality nascent iodine today at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
See, they ran into some Jewish folks who had, like, accents from Eastern Europe or maybe Israel. They're like, yeah, it's a free country, Christian iconography. We think it's beautiful. We like it. It's like, I could go to Egypt and see Egyptian stuff, and I think it's beautiful. Don't tear it down. I'm not offended by it. It's interesting to see other cultures and other ideas. See, those are true liberals who were tolerant. They were tolerant. But the difference is the globalists are overriding our culture with modern plastic corporatism. They're just in competition with everything they don't run and own. Leanne McAdoo's down there with Ja'Kari Jackson. Leanne, who are you with there?
I'm with some young thought criminals. They actually love celebrating Christmas. And what do you think? Do you want to have a Christmas celebration at school?
Yes, of course I do.
And what's your favorite thing about Christmas in school?
Presents.
Presents?
All I like is presents.
See, there you go. And you said they actually are allowed to celebrate Christmas in school.
I call it a holiday party, but yes, it's scheduled today. It's a Christmas party. Okay. Correct.
What about you? Are you a thought criminal? Come here. What do you think about? Does your teacher let you bring Christmas cards to school?
No, we usually don't. We usually just go there and have the party.
So you can't bring Christmas cards in?
We usually don't. We never ask.
Well, would you do that for a favor for me and bring some Christmas cards into your friends at school? Yes. Thought criminals in the making.
Oh my gosh, Leanne, this is so shocking. And there's a gun in the background. There's a cannon, a symbol of revolution. That's that's even worse. I mean, I'm offended by that. We've got to get...
I might go ask these gentlemen if they still believe that they're living in a free country. They're actually fans of the cannon there. I don't know if they understand the symbolism of that freedom.
Let me get a final comment from Ja'Kari and then walk over to those guys. Ja'Kari, what do you think about these thought criminals?
Oh, well, you know, they start young and these guys are well on their way to being some hardcore extremists believing that they have a First Amendment right in this country.
Yeah. Well, there's the headline, school bans display of a Christmas poster by a student because it might be religious. Again, you can have your own individual art you put out, and that display is not church and state. Let's march over to those thought criminals by the cannon and see if they think it should be banned as well as offensive. Ja'Kari. Okay. All right, here we go. Ja'Kari Jackson, Leanne McAdoo out there. And they're going to shoot some more reports and more interviews in high def out there. But look at that Skype. Looks awesome. And then I'm going to start having the reporters out almost every day. They're going to go to, like, book people events and Barnes & Noble events ahead of time to get interviews with people. Oh, here he is.
Oh, I heard.
Hi. Oh, my gosh. He must think it's a thought criminal to talk. Yeah, no, they're good. They know not to talk in America. Good.
Yeah, well, people are okay with mass surveillance as long as the cameras aren't right in their face.
Yeah, well, they'd rather imagine they're not there, Leanne. Leanne, any other points you'd like to make? And then final words from Jackson.
Well, it seems to me like everyone out here is just kind of in the Christmas spirit, and no one seems to be offended by the tree. They were a little frightened of me and my Kris Kringle outfit, but I think overall it's a win for freedom. What do you think, Jakari? Last word.
Oh, yeah, I think it is a win for freedom to see people actually care about their rights and are willing to stand up for them, even if it has to get to the point where it's their religious freedoms. If that's their line, I'm glad that they have
sure,
it.
Sure, sure. What's that Democrat's name that wants to abort all the babies and have it paid for by the government? Her name's Debbie something. Why don't you guys... Yeah, what's her name?
Isn't it Wendy?
Wendy Davis. Yeah. Why you guys ought to... And we can have you pop in like 45 minutes to 30 minutes after Amber Lyon's been on this for a while. Maybe you guys should go into her office. She probably isn't there. But just go in, get in, put your cameras together as news. Go in and then turn them back on once you get in. You know, do your report in there. You're pressed. They can't stop you. We've been in there many times. Everybody knows. We've stormed the Capitol, everybody knows. And then go in and ask her if she wants Christmas to be restricted and about the cards. I think that's newsworthy. So do that and then come on back. I know you got to host the news tonight, Leanne, with Jakari. But great job.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with a new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139. The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
See more women creating economic growth. Like the Goldman Sachs 10,000
Women. Everywhere you go, they're taking the crosses down and throwing them on the ground. The FEMA camps are just a false flag away. It's beginning to look a lot like Hitler. Gestapo at the airports, stripping you down to your shorts, but don't laugh or they'll haul you away. A prostate exam from an oversized hand is the wish of the TSA. Trauma-based mind control programming is the new American way.
We are on the march. The empire is on the run. Live from the Infowars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back live. Thank you so much for joining us. And we are seeing incredible censorship of the press. We are seeing just amazing religious persecution in this country. What Camille Paglia called the latest Duck Dynasty censorship, fascist and ultra-Stalinistic. We are seeing, in the name of political correctness, Soviet-style attacks on the First Amendment. And we defend the First Amendment, the Fourth Amendment, the Second Amendment, the Tenth Amendment. We defend it all. And we defend it all across the board as best we can. That's why we go out and demonstrate when they ban protesting or free speech at the 50th anniversary of Kennedy's assassination. That's why we go to the NSA building and protest what they're doing in Utah or in San Antonio. And that's why we have people like Amber Lyon on the broadcast, because she really is a hero. She was making a lot of money, was successful, had won 3 Emmys for journalism and for stories and best camera talent reporter. She covered all sorts of war zones and the BP oil spill, you name it. And then when there were Western-backed countries in the Middle East killing men, women, and children, and she was going to do reports on that, she got censored and told she couldn't, and the reports got killed, even though she was there and had the video, risking her life and others. And then she learned that these governments were paying, in some cases, $400,000 to kill each episode. So CNN was almost using her journalism as, behind the scenes, a blackmail tool, is really what's going on. Now CNN, since she left, is imploding into an entertainment channel. Piers Morgan had votes last night by his viewers, and they found that my appearance on his show was the highlight of the year. And it's because it broke with the script. And joining us from Australia on the international book tour for her new book, Peace, Love, and Pepper Spray, the big coffee table book full of photos but also blurbs and articles, is Peace, Love, and Pepper Spray. And when you buy it, we're not selling it, we should be, you are supporting true independent journalism. And while she talks, we'll flip through some of it on the air for you so you can see some of what she covers in here. But she gets into a whole area of pre-revolutionary protests, whiskey rebellions, slave rebellions, the labor movement, women's suffrage, civil rights. And then she moves into what's happening today, the Vietnam War, Kent State, gay rights, and then Pepper Sprayed, A Tale of Two. I mean, this is just a really powerful book. I couldn't put it down when I started looking at it today before the show. And regardless of what you think about it, it's a celebration of the First Amendment, a celebration of journalism, and cuts across political lines. So AmberLyonLive.com is the site. Amber, so good for you to stay up late. I mean, what time is it? 5, 6 o'clock in the morning in Australia?
Yeah, it's really early. It's about 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. here now, Alex. Thank you so much for having me on. It was worth waking up for.
Well, it's always good to see your beaming face and spirit. Well, you've got the floor. Tell us about what you're doing, what you've been through since you were on with us 6 months ago or so. And I know you were going to be on the nightly news tonight as well. But, I mean, just looking at all the things that are happening and the world and the NSA and just all of it coming out, just give us your take on the world in general.
Well, right now, I think the world is waking up. We're seeing an expanded consciousness worldwide that really fills me with a lot of hope, especially when you saw the American people and the people worldwide stand up and say, enough is enough, and we don't want this attack on Syria. To me, that was emblematic of a shift in consciousness we're facing worldwide, and something that can make all of us smile a little bit because the people are waking up. And since we last spoke, Alex, I've just been working on this book, and it's been a crazy but exciting journey. And I think the book is super important because I saw that the mainstream media was demonizing protest and making people think that protesters didn't have a sound message and protest was a waste of time. And I published this book to remind the American people that protest has been the common denominator for change throughout history. And if we want things to change, we're going to have to stand up and fight for our rights, Alex.
Well, you're absolutely right, Amber. And I know that, since you've been on with us, you've been traveling the world and doing investigative journalism in some dangerous situations. Tell us about some of your latest exploits.
Well, I as of now, I've been traveling investigating natural medicines. I feel like a lot of these medicines are being demonized. And not only that, they're being withheld from the American public in what I consider to be one of the greatest human rights tragedies of our generation. And so I've been, since March of last year, I've literally been on the road nonstop investigating these medicines. And I'm currently writing a book for people to show them how they can access them instead of just relying on prescription drugs, which are, as you know, Alex, you talk about this a lot on your show, turning the nation into zombies and addicts as well. One of my last stories I did for CNN was on these babies being born addicted to prescription medications. This NICU in East Tennessee literally had to build an extra wing just to handle all these babies being born addicted. And that's a story that's not being covered enough as well that I'm going to be covering in the book.
Wow.
But in addition to that, I finished up covering protests across the U.S. I traveled the U.S. for a year covering the Occupy protests, covering teacher protests, home foreclosure protests, really just any event where the little guy was standing up for his rights.
Talk to us about the nature of where you see the First Amendment as an award-winning journalist who's trained in understanding it with the way the free speech zones operate, the way the riot police operate. The way this culture is converting to what we see in third world countries and dictatorships, quite frankly, but they're still branding it as freedom because we went up to cover, you know, JFK and we're totally peaceful and we're physically attacked, punched, hit, you name it, for peacefully being there. The Dallas police said, no, you have a right to be here, First Amendment. And then the feds had the deputized sheriff's deputies physically attack us, and they looked like people out of central casting from a maximum security prison. Who did attack us. And it's just, you don't want to think bad of the police. You want to believe in the system. But when it becomes tyrannical in your face, you're a fool to deny it. So your book, incredible photojournalism in here, and firsthand accounts that it goes through, talk about the state of the First Amendment in this country.
Well, it's a disturbing state right now, Alex. Like you were describing, we're seeing a rampant amount of police militarization to the point that people are being intimidated to even hit the streets and protest. One of the protests I covered in the book, the Anaheim police brutality protest, ironically enough, the people were protesting against police brutality when the police started opening fire on crowds of women and children using less lethal rounds, which we all know can be lethal if they hit you in the head or in the wrong location. And I was even fired at by the Anaheim Police Department as I was standing in the middle of a busy street photographing a dumpster that had been set on fire. A wall of police started firing up on me. And I had to run. I was in such shock because, as you mentioned, Alex, I have traveled all around the world covering protests in countries that we consider to be run by dictators and we consider to be more dangerous than the U.S. But I have never been directly shot at like that in my entire career. And I was just in shock, and I had to run between two trucks to avoid being hit. And when I emerged from the truck screaming press, one of the officers said to me, "Don't you know how to cover a protest? You need to stand back here." And he pointed behind the police line where all the other journalists were corralled. And I believe I was fired upon because they didn't want me out there documenting these injuries. I had photographs of pedestrians who'd been hit in the back of their legs with these projectiles. And not only that, one of the next days when the protesters hit the streets, police showed up dressed in full camo gear, Alex. That was another double take I had to do. I felt like I was in Egypt. They were wearing camouflage clothing and military boots and heavily armed for a protest that it was almost a joke. Like you either had to laugh or cry because this protest consisted mostly of Hispanic women and children who were unarmed. It's we're just seeing a disturbing rate of this police militarization, and I definitely expose that in the book because it just became a common thread at all of these protests, Alex, and people like to believe we have the freedom to exercise our First Amendment rights in the United States, but when you have police directly intimidating protesters, then we're not able to do so. And I know a lot of police are good. You know, police officers, many of them do get in the field to protect our freedoms, but they're doing the exact opposite. And as a failure.
Well, that's right. That's right. The directive from on top is towards authoritarianism. And as you know, our government and the special interests that control it are on record all over the world trying to put authoritarian regimes in because they want to manage and extract the resources. They're treating us exactly the same. So this is a top-down operation.
Exactly. And why, where's the outrage, Alex? Like, why, this is what I don't understand. Why aren't the people saying enough is enough and really standing up and fighting back against this police militarization? This is a slippery slope. And we're seeing this. I mean, even from when I started covering the protests in September 2011 to now, look at the change in the police attire. Police are now heading to these protests dressed like they're in some Judge Dredd movie. And I think they're doing that because they're getting away with it. The American public is allowing this to happen and sitting back and not standing up for our rights.
Now, Amber, when we come back, I want to get into some of the big breaking news of the NSA, free speech in America, the attack on the press. I want to get your take as a journalist on the things that are happening here right now. And then tell us what you're seeing over in Australia. I'm Alex Jones, folks. Stay with us.
Great news, pure water lovers. BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com has a special discount offer for all GCN listeners. You can't do better than a Big Berkey for economy. For only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. There's none better than a Big Berkey for emergency preparedness as a backup water source. And you just can't beat a Big Berkey to remove dangerous chlorine, all types of fluoride, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, parasites, and unhealthy byproducts from municipal water. Berkey water filter systems are even powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. For the gold standard in water filters, get a Big Berkey at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And all GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. For details, call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey water filters, for the love of clean water.
You better watch out, you sure better cry. You're at least gonna pout, and I'm telling you why. Privacy is leaving your town.
Is your cell phone being used to build a profile on you? Give the gift of privacy and block unwanted cell phone spying with the Privacy Case from PrivacyCase.com.
They're making their list, they're checking them twice. They're gonna make up who's been naughty or nice.
The problem is real, and so is the solution. Go to PrivacyCase.com because
they see you when you're sleeping.
Now through December 31st, buy yourself an American-made privacy case and give one for only $79.95 each. Go to PrivacyCase.com today. The Privacy Case, because there is a case for privacy.
Ladies and gentlemen, America is more dangerous than ever, with 9 million property crimes last year. Crimes are happening every day. Be proactive and protect your home and family. Simply Safe Home Security System helps guard against criminals, thugs, and thieves. Listen, Simply Safe is the absolute best alarm system and company in America today. Here's why. We offer a 60-day money-back guarantee. It's affordable, no contracts to sign, and is built with the latest wireless technology. Simply Safe protects the ones you love the most, even if a criminal cuts your power and phone lines. When you order today, you'll receive a 10% discount along with a free keychain remote. Don't wait. This offer is only valid through January 31st. Take advantage of this special discount offer at GetSimplySafe.com. That's GetSimplySafe.com. Protect your home and family now at GetSimplySafe.com.
There's no reason to be sick this season with Supernatural Silver's incredible technology. You can give your immune system the support it needs to help fight off colds, flus, and other nasty pathogens that can ruin the holidays for you and those you love. Used internally or topically, Supernatural Silver is a great defense against sore throats, runny noses, sinus or ear infections, and a whole host of other illnesses. Supernatural Silver is extremely safe and a great way to protect yourself and the ones you love. No one knows what the future may bring, so be smart and plan ahead. Have Supernatural Silver in your emergency preparedness arsenal and give someone a gift that's meaningful, a gift that can change lives. Give the gift of good health this year. Go to supernaturalsilver.com and use the promo code SILVER2013 for 20% off your entire order. That's supernaturalsilver.com. And like us on Facebook.
This. We're about to have our reporters in about 15 minutes with Amber Lyon as well via Australia go in and ask some of the state reps if they support Texas schools banning Christmas cards, basically of any type, being handed out. Again, that's free individual will to hand out a Christmas card. It's not the school saying, here's our official religion. This is real tyranny, folks. And so they're going to be inside the Capitol via Skype, crystal clear. We're talking to Amber Lyon, award-winning journalist, and has her new book out, Peace, Love, and Pepper Spray, from Australia. This is really the future, because they can use all this technology. There's a New York Times article breaking it down to surveil us and control us. But if we use the technology to empower real media and to take action, there's nothing they can do, because there's billions of us and only a few thousand top globalists and a few tens of millions of their minions worldwide. NSA Dragnet includes allies, aid groups, and business elite. I was told by NSA whistleblowers over a decade ago that it's mainly to steal technological information from other companies and give it to globalist companies, not American companies. And the White House has been forced to come out and admit a lot of this to take the sting out of all the info that's beginning to come out. So going back to Amber Lyon, Amber, where are you specifically in Australia right now?
I'm in Sydney.
How incredible is it that you can be in Australia, I can be here in Austin, I've got reporters on the street. I mean, if the citizens start using this and seeing themselves as important, which they are, it's over. Most of the news we end up breaking now comes from our listeners. Mainstream media doesn't even know how to do that. So how are you as a professional journalist, now as a guerrilla journalist, how do you see that fusing together in the future?
Well, are you talking about the ability to use, you know, report news on your cell phone?
Sure, or just everything. I mean, what do you see this revolution? I don't see the establishment being able to control it.
No, I don't think so either. And I think they're shaking in their boots. It's quite disturbing for them that they can't control it anymore. And I think Syria was the perfect example of that. And that's where social media spread the truth about what was happening on the ground in Syria. And it spread so rapidly across the tentacles of the web that the elite's narrative wasn't accepted by the public. And the public stood up and said, we're not going to enter. And as far as just social media in general, as a journalist, I always tell journalism students, I'm so jealous of these young journalists just getting into the field right now, because they have so much power. All you need to do is set up a website and have a, you know, even just a cell phone camera and take donations off your website, and you can bypass the dinosaur gatekeepers of the media and have your own success. And we've seen a lot of journalists do that as well. One of them who's doing it very well is, you know, not only you, Alex, also journalists who've just taken it into their own hands to create their own entity online. And that used to be nearly impossible, because you had all these gatekeepers really controlling the message. So for me, this all gives me a lot of hope, because the people are taking back the power, and we're seeing this happen at a rate that cannot be controlled anymore.
You're right. I want to shift gears and talk about free speech with you. Whether you agree with what the Duck Dynasty patriarch said, or whether you disagree, or whether you agree, I mean, it doesn't matter for me. The fact is, he said it in a magazine interview, and now they've kicked him off the show. And it's the same thing with the Christmas cards. Kids should be able to hand out Christmas cards. That's their personal free speech. And I really see out of the so-called left more and more authoritarianism. I'm just a libertarian. And I see in your book, you know, the story of people on the left and the right being abused. But are you concerned about out-of-control political correctness, or what is your view on the Duck Dynasty controversy?
Well, I think that any time that someone is censored because of their beliefs, that I don't accept it, especially as a journalist who was censored. You know, you're just seeing the corporate control of the media, and it's really just making it so, it's just dumbing down society, because anytime anyone speaks anything politically, they're censored. And, sure. And that, not only that, it sends a chilling effect across all of these shows.
Well, that's right. And it's left, right, center, libertarian. Anything that's pertinent, anything that makes waves, they shut it down. And they can say, well, we own the printing press. Yeah, but they got it through fraud, through collusion. And it's so centralized. And then they're trying to create a chilling effect, like with you. I mean, you exposed war crimes, and then they blocked it, and then you learned they've been paid off.
Exactly, and that was very disturbing for me as a journalist, because at one end of the building, my crew and I were risking our lives to expose this brutal regime, and then at the other end of the building, CNN was taking money from them in exchange for producing these positive programmings that made the regime look look like they were democratic and really helping the people, when what we saw on the ground was the exact opposite. And I believe, Alex, that that's happening across the board within the corporate press, especially because after I exposed what was happening at CNN, I didn't get much mainstream coverage, which was kind of, for me, indicative of the fact that a
You're
lot
right.
of these...
Stay there. We're going to come back and talk about that with our guest straight ahead, Amber Lyon.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented. A 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield Nascent Iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield Nascent Iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Alex Jones here with a message to fellow freedom lovers. The prognosis for the entire planetary economic system runs from bad to worse. The globalist model is to shut down societies and starve patriots out until they acquiesce to the global takeover. That's why we've assembled the most vital and important preparedness items at InfoWarsShop.com. These are items that I did research on, that I personally use. We've got the Life Straw, so you can turn fetid water into safe water anywhere you go. The K-Tor hand crank generator to charge up key equipment during power outages or out in the field. Strategic Relocation, 3rd edition by Joel Skousen. When Disaster Strikes by Matthew Stein. TheraSafe, used by Homeland Security to protect yourself during any radiological event. Hand crank shortwave AM/FM radios. Everything that we've researched and found to be the best is available at InfoWarsShop.com, and your purchase makes our InfoWar possible. We're getting prepared. Are you? InfoWarsShop.com. Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. Live from the InfoWars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
Here's some of the headlines up on InfoWars.com. Support for A&E boycott, four times higher than Obamacare enrollment. Boehner calls for one-year Obamacare delay. Yeah, the insurance companies have already gotten the law changed to make you buy it and jack up the price. They want to back it off a little just so they can actually keep it. That's what Boehner wants to do. The Republicans helped write it. New Facebook page, boycott A&E, support free speech. That's our page. And again, it needs to go viral, ladies and gentlemen. Please like it. Please send it on your Twitter and on your Facebook account. Everybody needs to do that so we can defend the First Amendment together. And, of course, you can guess who tops Piers Morgan's most 10 memorable moments of 2013. It's yours truly, and it's an interesting article. Notice those cowards admit the highest ratings he's ever had but won't have me back on because it isn't about ratings. It's about control. And so that's some of the articles up on InfoWars.com. Going back to Amber Lyon, who was censored at CNN and basically pressured to leave, but she left, I guess, on her own accord. She can remind me if I'm wrong, but I'm going from memory. For going to battle zones and seeing Western-backed regimes killing men, women, and children, she had the footage. It later came out that it was true. And then she later learned that those governments were literally, what was it, $400,000 being paid to CNN to spike your story? I mean, that's incredible. Recap that briefly because it's so important. And then I want to tie it into all the things we see happening today and where you see this going.
Well, CNN never gave, I even requested to get an amount of money that they are getting paid by the Bahrain Economic Development Board, and they never revealed that. I don't know where the $400,000 figure comes from, but as far as my reporting goes, we weren't able to reveal an exact amount, but we did find out that CNN was getting paid by the Bahrain regime, and not only by Bahrain, but by regimes worldwide, in exchange for producing positive content disguised as news that they sprinkled into their regular programming with little or no disclosure to viewers, and not only little or no disclosure to viewers, but no disclosure to CNN's own reporters. And so what happened is I had gone to Bahrain to cover the uprising there, and we discovered some, uncovered some pretty brutal crimes by that regime that's being backed by the U.S. And when I got back to the United States, at first I was able to go on CNN and report on what was happening, and then it became I had more and more red tape go up. It became nearly impossible to get stories on about Bahrain, and our documentary on the Arab Spring and the Bahrain Revolution, which was one of the most damning reports against this regime to date, never aired on CNN International. And after some prompting by executives who wrote me and said that you should investigate this, that something suspicious is going on, we were able to uncover that CNN had been getting paid by Bahrain. Bahrain was a paying customer there for years.
Yeah, I saw a news story where it came out, and that's where I get that memory, of where one of those governments, it was 400 plus thousand for some of the PR stuff. And it's, again, CNN is not disclosing this. And now I see the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation on ABC News, the London Guardian, CNN, where on the site it will say, this week on ABC News, brought to you by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. But you watch it, it's their whole agenda during the show, never telling you that. And it just shows the propaganda placement is getting worse and worse.
And that was the problem at CNN, is that they have been taking money from Kazakhstan, the Ukraine, Nigeria, Lebanon, Bahrain, and they've been just sprinkling these programs that they were paid by these regimes to create into the regular news programming. So it, with little or no disclosure to viewers. So the average viewer would probably have no idea they're watching a sponsored segment. And that to me was what I found the most disturbing. Not only that, as a journalist, that I wasn't told that that the regime I was investigating was also a paying customer at the network. And so above all, I think we're having a little bit of a disconnect with these networks, Alex, as to what is true journalism. Journalism is printing what someone else doesn't want printed. Everything else is public relations. And we're just seeing too much public relations now and advertising mixed in the mix. And it makes it very difficult to trust these networks for an accurate picture of what's happening overseas, not only overseas, but sure. Here in the U.S.
And I have an article here out of Reuters, superbug bacteria widespread in U.S. chicken consumer group, and that a lot of people are getting sick from it. So if you have some little plant that has salmonella and gets a few people sick, they'll shut it down. But big agri gets to radiate it. They get to spray all these special chemicals on them. And it turns out it's not just governments. Out of the top 100 economies, over 50 of them are corporations, not governments. They're all in there. It turned out with Fox over a decade ago making payoffs and advertising to not let local Fox reporters in Florida do a report on studies of what the synthetic growth hormone was doing to people. I mean, no kidding it was making kids grow weird. No kidding it was making people go into puberty early. And they got shut down. And so it's just, it's everywhere. It's absolutely everywhere. I know for a fact that in radio, because I've worked in radio, and when I worked at these stations, you would sign non-disclosure. So it was not me that they were censoring. It was the fact that I just couldn't talk about the news segment because I discovered it and asked. I mean, I was ignorant like 16 years ago, 17 years ago. I'd say, we're paid in the news to have the person read this? That's actually paid. And they go, yeah. And keep your mouth shut. You got a non-disclosure. And I learned that was at all the big news stations. And then they got a huge contract by a state quasi-corporate entity. And then basically they came in, it was the LCRA, Lower Colorado River Authority, and said, we don't want you to ever talk about the LCRA. They're a news sponsor. But I went, who are they? I didn't know 16 years ago. Then I looked into them, and it's like basically a mafia. I'm not saying everybody there is bad, but it's a big water grab by corporate interests that get the money. They've had a bunch of scandals. I mean, that's how involved they were. And later I was kind of told, listen, dummy, you're not going to be on the air soon. We're getting other payments. And so later, only years later did I click, all this state and federal money came in to get me off the air. And I think from doing the research that I was partially taken off my first radio job because of money from the government.
And a similar thing happened to me at CNN. I mean, Bahrain, the actual regime would call the news desk to complain about my reporting. And after repeated calls, I started noticing that it became more and more difficult for me to get stories online. And I was forced to ridiculous statements from this regime that we knew was Gaddafi and Assad-esque. And instead, I had to, instead of taking them for what they were, I had to actually include their lies, which included statements saying that protesters were putting makeup on to fake their injuries and fake blood. I mean, I had to include these ridiculous statements into my reporting, Alex. And I believe the network just acquiesced to its paying customer. And that's what we're seeing across the board in the mainstream media. And as long as I've been in the field of journalism and worked for the mainstream, I've been censored at every single job I've had. So I'm a firm believer now it's nearly impossible to do muckraking investigative journalism at these outlets. And that's why it's so important to support the independent media, because they're the only ones able to actually report the truth 100%.
And as that comes out, and as people learn that all these big channels are bought and paid for, and even local news channels are, people are leaving them in mass, so there's a vacuum for people to not go to college to be a journalist. I'm not saying that's a total waste, but you don't have time, folks. Go out, follow it, do the story, report it. You're not going to be perfect. Just get your facts right. We all see through rose-colored glasses from our own prejudices deep down and things, but just stand up for the Bill of Rights and Constitution. Stand up for common sense. Pick issues you're concerned with, start a blog, be a photojournalist, shoot video, go cover protests, support the First Amendment, support liberty, and there's no way they'll stop us all. There's a reason they want to shut down the independent press. There's a reason they want to attack protesters that are peaceful, to create a chilling effect, because the system knows we've got the moral right. They want to control that, and that's why when you put out a book like this, and I think it's self-published, isn't it?
No, it's published by Whitman Press. They were an amazing company who really, they don't normally do political books, Alex. It took a lot of convincing, but at the end
Well, I know who they are, so I think they do put out their own books, but I think they also help folks. But that is just fantastic that they did this with you. And so people should get your book to support your ongoing journalism. They should support InfoWars.com. They should buy our products. They should support everybody. Ron Paul's media operation, Ben Swine. Everybody, I'm not in competition with any of these new journalists, whether they be more liberal-leaning or conservative-leaning or libertarian-leaning. If they just tell the truth and promote basic liberty, we're all brothers and sisters in this together.
Exactly, and I think it's super important to support the independent outlets. I mean, that's the best way, I think, to give money if you're about to donate to charity, because that's kind of what journalism has had to become. I mean, we now rely on donations because it is difficult to work for these outlets anymore and to play with the system. And so we've had to become almost like a nonprofit to survive as journalists.
Exactly. And now the fascist Dianne Feinstein wants to restrict everybody else, take away any tax exemption from private groups. Of course, we don't have that, but others. And then the government will decide if you're a journalist and if you have journalistic protection. Give us your take on that movement, Fairness Doctrine for Talk Radio. And then we're going to cut to our reporters in the field, Leanne McAdoo and Jakari Jackson, who I know may have a few questions for you. Leanne's going to be interviewing you tonight. And then, of course, you can take the talk in any direction you want. And so give us a preview of what you're going to talk about on the nightly news tonight, a double serving of the intelligent and also, of course, beautiful Amber Lyon with, of course, our reporter Leanne McAdoo. But give us your take on the move to have the government declare who's a journalist and who isn't.
I just think that's ridiculous, because most of the journalists who we're calling journalists are lapdogs these days, not watchdogs. So I consider more of the independent press to be the more real journalists. But the way the government wants to word it, the mainstream journalists would be considered journalists, whereas the independent press would be at risk of as not being considered journalists by the government. So I think it's something that's so changing right now and evolving that it's nearly impossible to define. And I think if you are out there exposing government crimes and writing about it and being a watchdog, you are a journalist. And you don't need a definition, and a definition is only to further make it so that the independent press can be just considered bloggers and potentially face criminal charges or be forced to reveal their sources.
And Amber Lyon, you're not just as important as CNN or as the New York Times. You're more important because you've shown that you got forced out of CNN, where you were, a rock star, up and comer, taking over 3 Emmys. You got forced out for your integrity. You left via your integrity. And so you're not on par with CNN. You're above them. And it shows that CNN's bought off, that they had record viewers for Piers Morgan's history when I was on. And they admitted to me when I saw his producers in Houston that, no, we want you on. The higher ups have said no. And they said, we want you back on. We want ratings, but we've been told no. So if I failed in that interview yelling at him, no, I didn't. I broke the spell. I said, look, this is all a fraud. You're paid by Big Pharma to put kids on drugs that are making them kill people. The insert says it, Piers Morgan. It says it can make you be a mass murderer. So stop blaming my Second Amendment when, if you want to blame anything, it's your sponsors. That's why they're scared to have me back on, even though it's been voted number one thing of the year. What do you say to that?
Well, it's true. There are decisions being made, and I saw it directly when I was working there, that had nothing to do with the journalistic value or getting viewers. And that was something that I couldn't wrap my head around while I was there, because I would come up sometimes with some story ideas that I knew would really generate a significant audience and had a lot of journalistic value. And those stories were sidelined. And I couldn't quite figure out what the reasoning was, but there are decisions being made there that aren't that have nothing to do with the journalistic value of a story or getting viewers, and that's disturbing. It's who's making these decisions and why. And we saw that with the Occupy movement as well.
That's what we cover here, is if it's important, it's breaking, it affects our liberties. We don't think black, white, old, young, male, female, Christian, not Christian, Muslim, whatever, gay, not gay. We think, is it freedom? Who's the little guy? You know, is it the system trying to take our rights? And then we go out and report on it. And then, of course, for us, that's exciting. That's exciting to everybody else. And so we're successful. I mean, telling the truth is successful. People want it. Amber Lyon's our guest till the end of the hour. And we're going to go now and get her take on this. Leanne McAdoo and Jakari Jackson are there at the Capitol. They've been doing Man on the Street out there about the Texas making kids not be able to bring Christmas cards to the schools. And we've had that report up earlier, and Leanne joins us. Leanne, before you go in after the break and talk to one of the state reps about their view on this, would you like to say anything to Amber Lyon, who you're going to be interviewing tonight?
Well, hello, Amber. Obviously, you had to deal with, you know, suppression of the press, but what do you think about the fact that Texas actually had to pass a law to allow people to just say Merry Christmas or hand out Christmas cards?
I just think it's a slight overreach, and it's obvious you guys are reporting on it. It's just ridiculous.
Well, they had to pass the law, but still schools aren't letting kids hand out Christian Christmas cards, or even if it has a tree, they're saying no. And now the school's backed off, but here's a headline today, Newsmax. Christmas trees banned at Texas school called draconian. And, I mean, it is a Christian holiday, but it's not even religious to have a Christmas tree. I mean, this is crazy. We're losing all our basic rights. We're losing our Fourth Amendment. We got foreign banks robbing us. We've got our press being bought off by foreign companies and foreign governments. And then they're making the threat, Amber, a Christmas tree.
Yeah. And I think anytime I'm glad you guys are highlighting this story, anytime we face any infractions on our First Amendment rights, it's just a slippery slope. And so what's going to be banned next? And that's what disturbs me in this situation. And that's why I'm glad you guys are taking the lead in covering this story.
Well, when we come back here in just a minute, they're going to walk into a state rep's office and ask them, and I'm sure they're just going to say no comment. It'll be 1 minute, and then we can come back to you and finish talking about the book. But let me go back to McAdoo here as we have 1 minute till we go to break, and we'll come back with our guest talking about her book, Peace, Love, and Pepper Spray. Leanne, real quick, whose office have you chosen to go in and ask if they support schools violating the state law, not letting people have free speech and hand out Christmas cards?
We're going to go speak with Senator Wendy Davis.
Okay, so do you have any idea if she's there?
I don't believe so. It looks like everyone's out for the season, so.
But, I mean, is there an aide there you can talk to?
Yeah, well, there's someone there at the front door.
Okay, fantastic. So we're going to go to break. When we come back in 3 minutes, we're going to go right to that, and I'm sure we're just pointing out that we know, and then it'll come to the senator's attention. Last time I read, she was, you know, not supporting the bill to let folks have trees and stuff in public. I mean, it's just ridiculous. I mean, come on, we don't go to other countries and say, well, the majority's Muslim, so you can't have Muslim, you know, days or whatever. It's just ridiculous. Our guest is Amber Lyon. The book is Peace, Love, and Pepper Spray. It's a coffee table photojournalist book, but with also great articles. Everybody should get it. We'll tell you where you can get it when we come back.
You better watch out, you sure better cry. Your lease gonna pout, and I'm telling you why. Privacy is leaving your town.
Is your cell phone being used to build a profile on you? Give the gift of privacy and block unwanted cell phone spying with the Privacy Case from privacycase.com.
They're making their list, they're checking them twice. They're gonna make up who's been naughty or nice.
The problem is real, and so is the solution. Go to privacycase.com because
they see you when you're sleeping. They listen when you're awake. They can tell us all you've been bad when you've been good. So get yourself a privacy case.
Oh, now through December 31st, buy yourself an American-made privacy case and give one for only $79.95 each. Go to privacycase.com today. The Privacy Case, because there is a case for privacy.
Bulletproof glass is great if you don't mind being shot at without being able to defend yourself. It's said the best defense is a strong offense, an overwhelming offense. At OffTheGrid.com, we couldn't agree more. Return Fire Bulletproof Glass disintegrates bullets fired at you on impact, while you're able to return fire on your aggressor from the other side. Your bullets hit their mark, unobstructed by the Return Fire Glass. Your aggressor won't know what hit him.
Man down.
Return Fire Bulletproof Glass, available exclusively at OffTheGrid.com. Handgun protection rated up to 44 caliber. Rifle protection to 7.62x39. Call it revolutionary risk management for an uncertain world. Check out the full line of return fire products, including riot shields and clipboards at offthegrid.com. Offthegrid.com. Proud to stand shoulder to shoulder with you as we protect our Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
To thank you for being a loyal listener, we have a limited time freebie offer for you. Claim your free heirloom tomato seeds, just pay shipping, right now at 123freeseeds.com. These aren't ordinary seeds. These are heirloom, non-genetically modified super seeds that are open pollinated and can be grown, harvested, and replanted endlessly. These survival seeds are actually more valuable than gold in a crisis. Go to 123freeseeds.com and you can get an airtight storage packet of 150 super seeds free while supplies last to say thank you for being a loyal listener. First come, first served. Just cover shipping. Go to 123freeseeds.com now to see if your free heirloom seeds are still available. That's 123freeseeds.com.
All right, I've been watching live feeds during the break. TV viewers at prisonplanet.tv could see it without the audio. Some guy came up where they were in the Capitol and looked like he said they couldn't be there and directed them into a side office. And look, he gave them hall passes or something. You don't need that to be in the Capitol. I mean, I go in there all the time. I don't get permits to protest either. Jakari or Leanne, what just happened? Leanne, tell us.
Well, they just told us that we need to seek permission to bow before our senators and to get footage.
During our commercial break, Alex, we were out in the Senate gallery and a very nice gentleman named Austin came over and told us that we need to seek permission to film the Senate gallery. I did inform the gentleman that it's not our intention to film the Senate. Told him we wanted to speak to one of our representatives.
But there is no Senate in session, and you don't need permission. It's a right when it's not in session. Yeah. He's just henpecking you to be your boss, and I don't care if he's polite. Robbing our First Amendment, even though he's doing it polite, isn't nice. What has he now said to you?
He's basically given us the address where we can seek permission to film here and...
Yeah, but notice there's no state police talking. The state police are not talking to you because that's made up. So ignore him and go in Wendy Davis's office. Where is that?
It's right behind us.
All right, go walk in there. My God, or let me talk to that idiot. Anyways, all right, so it's closed, it's gone. We're the press there showing it.
Davis, is anybody available to make a statement on her behalf?
There they are.
How can we get in touch with her? Can we send a call or email? Or I see one of these business cards. Is that the best way?
I mean, this guy literally is just trying to henpeck us out of there. The state police didn't stop him. You don't need... Media's in there every day and doesn't get permission. Okay, I'm sick of color of law crud. Let me get Amber Lyon's take on this, three-time Emmy Award-winning CNN journalist. This is what we're talking about. There is no law. There is no regulation. There is no permission to be in the Capitol unless you're in somebody's private office where he drug them in there. I mean, what do you make of this another bureaucrat? It's not the state police. They know the law. What do you make of the bureaucrat trying to do that?
Well, I think that they're trying to avoid your questions more than anything. And I think that you do have a right to be there, obviously, as reporters. And I'm appreciative of your efforts to actually hold political elites accountable and not become lapdogs like you see at these mainstream press conferences where the press just becomes puppets to the authorities.
Sure.
I think that your approach is a true investigative journalist approach. And that's when you should be walking up to these officials with a microphone in hand, questioning them about their behaviors.
Exactly. Now, Leanne was going to interview you and tape it for the news tonight. I know you're doing a big speaking tour there. Would you like to take a 30-minute break when this show ends and have Leanne get back and interview you, or do you want it to be David Knight?
It's whatever you think, whatever you prefer works for me.
Okay. I mean, so you want to take a 35-minute break or so? She'll get back, and then we'll call you on Skype, and then you can talk about whatever you want with her tonight. They were asking me. I've been asking the questions. I'd like to have you on and just basically cover whatever you want with Leanne. How's that sound?
Okay. That sounds great. Wonderful. I can take 30 minutes. I've got time.
Okay. You're very sweet to do that. If not, David Knight's a great reporter. I mean, he'll do the interview, too. Just it's up to you. What do you want to do?
Yeah, I can wait for Leanne. That's fine. It's only about 6:50 in the morning here. So
right. Well, get some coffee or take a nap, and then she'll be back in 30 minutes, and then she'll get it fired up and do the interview for the news tonight. Thank you, Amber. Briefly, how do folks get your new book?
Yeah, you can go to peaceloveandpepperspray.com and order the book there. And also, I have special signed copies that really help promote and support my journalism on the site that you can buy as well. So right, just head to peaceloveandpepperspray.com.
Say it one more time.
Peaceloveandpepperspray.com.
All right, Amber, we're going to let you go. We'll call you back in about 30 minutes for the interview with Leanne McAdoo.
All right. Sounds good. Thanks, Alex.
Thank you. All right, Leanne, closing comments. Are they saying anything else to you there where you try to defend Christmas at the Capitol?
No, they're behind a locked, bulletproof door. And it's standard procedure. It seems to be with the same with the Obama administration. If you're a journalist, if you're a reporter, they just direct you to the White House website to get your talking points.
Yeah, well, you know what he did. He literally just made up stuff to you. Of course, you need permission to talk to a senator, but not to be in the Capitol. So he did that. He did it very politely, but it was an attempt to violate your First Amendment. So I want you to talk to that rat again and then have it on the nightly news, because I want to show what he did. We're going to do a little bit of overdrive, but Leanne, get on back to the office with Jakari. Great job.
Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to big pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products, and get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin, you're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Folks, we're into overdrive right now. I got to most of the news today, but some of it I didn't get to that was very important. It'll be covered tonight, 7 o'clock Central. InfoWars Nightly News. Sometimes it's live, sometimes it's taped to air. A lot of times the interviews are taped before the show is at 7. For a couple of months, we did it live every night. Because we're going to do that once we officially launch in the new studio, is have it live quite a bit of the time and then have tape packages that air. It'll be a 30-minute show, but it'll have a second half. It's another 30 minutes of stations, one an hour. And we're building all this, doing all this while broadcasting, while doing the news, while doing the magazine, the films, the commercials, the products to fund ourselves. That's why they've had major trade publications out there like Talkers and New York Times and others say that InfoWars.com and what I've done is trailblazing how to build new media. Now, it doesn't mean I'm even good at it now. Other people with more money and stuff have already gone past us. With audiences and effectiveness. Our message, I believe, is the most constitutional pro-liberty. And I'm very proud of what we've done, but I am not in competition with other journalists and people that are fighting for liberty. If they're not authoritarians and they care about justice and they are not eugenicists, I don't care if they are liberal, conservative, Christian, not Christian, gay, straight, whatever it is. We're in so much trouble with the New World Order, folks. We have to come together for basic freedom. It's about state-run media versus independent media. It's about fascism versus libertarian ideas, as Matt Drudge famously tweeted. And that is what we're dealing with here. And I am very excited that Glenn Beck doesn't attack me anymore and make stuff up and has gotten more hardcore against the New World Order. Because I didn't used to attack him, just because I wanted to. I did it because he'd lie about me and get things wrong. Maybe he's woken up. I'm not in competition with any of these people. I want to make money so that I can build the best news organization out there and protect ourselves and be strong and beat the globalist. I want to win. And we have to realize we need to be ready to win. We need to think like winners and think about taking our civilization back and not think of this all as a foregone conclusion and evil can't be beaten and, oh my God, and everybody's an agent and blah, 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 blah. Believe me, I know a lot of good people. I know I'm a good guy. I know I'm for real. I mean, I don't like being a slave. I take it real personal. It's a drug to fight control freaks. It is a drug to be the underdog and beat them. It is a drug. I mean, it is a drug. It is a drug to have 300 people in a protest in Dallas and the last 30 that stay with you get attacked by the police after 4 hours in the rain, and then to take them all into a warm hotel and buy them all hot tea and hamburgers and hot chocolate and stuff. I mean, it's like just goodness is so good. It sounds incredibly cheesy, but that's what it all comes down to. And I just want to commend all of you that have helped us over the years. We couldn't have done this. The station managers, the owners, the sponsors, the listeners, the people praying for us. And I'm trying to live up to everything I need to do and everything I need to be. I try to be a good man. I try to spend time with my children. I try to not, you know, look at other women. I mean, I feel bad when I'm a you know, dirty dog. But I am a good person in my heart, and I know you are as well. And that's what it comes down to, ladies and gentlemen, is that it's those of us that want good. More and more I realize that's what separates from good and evil. There's people that really like evil and corruption. Those of us that don't like it doesn't mean we're perfect. We just don't like it, and we want to reach for the good. We want to make the decision to try to be better people and try to build a better world, and that's where all the blessings come from. So if you're not a PrisonPlanet.tv member, become one. It takes about a minute to sign up with your credit card or debit card. That way you can mail in a check and over the phone they can give you a code, make one for you or whatever. Yearly memberships, you can get 5 months. It's like 5.3 months free when you sign up for a year during December. And then that membership you can give to 11 people with the same username and passcode. Or you can get a monthly membership for $5.95 and you can share it with 11 people as well. Give it to people in e-cards or in a physical card. Some will watch it, some won't, but that's a great way to wake people up, not fight the crowds, and not go broke. PrisonPlanet.tv. Become a member today, and you can save 5.3 months free off the year right now. That's PrisonPlanet.tv, and the nightly news is coming up 7. I'll be on this Sunday.
Hi, folks. Ronnie McMullen here for Life Change Tea. Healthcare is a problem, whether you're for or against Obamacare. It's a mess. My question is, who do you trust? Do you want to be told what to do, or do you want to make your own decision? My opinion, preventative maintenance. Keeping your colon clean is preventative maintenance.